fans are ready. The Baylor line, there they go, here at McLean Stadium in Waco, Texas, to kick off the Big 12 season for number 3 Oklahoma against the Baylor Bears. They are ready, and so are we. Hello there, everybody. Justin Kutcher alongside Petros Papadakis and Mark Helfrich. And, Coach, let's start with you. Oklahoma, they're riding a 13-game winning streak, the longest in college football. They have a quarterback in Baker Mayfield who, I know it's early, but he's already a Heisman frontrunner. What do you see when you watch Baker Mayfield?
Confidence. It's one word. This guy oozes confidence. Sometimes it's pregame, as we just saw, or postgame, or Twitter, or with a flag. But the guy can bring it. Video game stats, when you look at it, he started his career well, and it's only gotten better. So far in his career, 29 starts at OU, 29 games with a touchdown pass. Baylor has to have every phase involved to stop him today.
You mentioned those 29 games with a touchdown pass. His last 16, he has thrown at least 2 touchdown passes in those games. So he is certainly playing at an elite level right now. For Baylor right now, Petros, this is a team under a new regime. Matt Rhule is here, and Matt Rhule says for this first game in the Big 12, he wants to get back to playing Matt Rhule-style football.
Well, we talk about culture changes, but what's happening here at Baylor under Coach Rhule is very different. I mean, they want to do everything differently, especially run the ball. 50 times a game is what he did at Temple, and now they have Terrence Williams back, recovering from a shoulder surgery in the offseason, a 1,000-yard rusher from last year, 6'2", 240, 230 around. He is strong and can take it to that Oklahoma defense, and that'll keep Baker on the sideline. That's exactly what the Bears need.
They are ready, and why not, to kick off this Big 12 season. The Baylor Bears take the field here at McLean Stadium. Kickoff is coming up next with number 3 Oklahoma and Baylor here on FS1.
Sir Jeremy, you are a
4 p.m. local time. Oklahoma and Baylor around midfield. The guys started some trash talking. And then a couple of hours later, the trash talking turns to rampage. The drill for Baylor, get some of that aggression out. Take it out early. Get ready for this Big 12 opener. And here they are, the Baylor Bears, coming into this game 0-3. 94 degrees as we get set to kick off. 35% humidity. Oklahoma coming in 3-0, number 3 in the country. Guys, how about the keys to the game today, sponsored by Ford?
Well, for OU, it's focus on today. We've already seen a couple teams, FSU going down. Focus on right now. It's not Bedlam. It's not the college football playoff. It's not anything else but beating the Baylor Bears down in, down out.
And this is a Big 12 matchup. It's different. These teams know each other. Baylor has an opportunity to find their identity at home in a packed house. We talked about Terrence Williams running the ball. That's exactly what they want to do, be more physical.
Well, Baylor won the toss. They have deferred, so Oklahoma will receive. Drew Galitz will kick off. Back deep is Jeff Badette. And we are underway here at McLean Stadium. Badette from the 1. Badette has a hole. Down the sideline, Badette, all the way down inside the 30. Finally tackled by Chris Platt.
Well, just a great job scheme-wise here by OU on special teams. Baylor just gets one guy right there out of his lane. And Badette's world-class. We can't quite beat the kicker to go all the way. And Platt, another world-class sprinter, gets him down. That's actually a great effort.
That's a great effort by the kicker, yep. Coach. Come on.
Get him to break stride.
Drew Galitz did a great job trying to get him down. And Platt, the 400 runner, needed all of that stride to run him down. What a beautiful kick return to start the game for OU.
A 70-yard return for Jeff Badette gives great starting field position for Baker Mayfield. On first down, the handoff to Abdul Adams up the middle. And Adams up the 24-yard line, picks up 5. This is not the start that Baylor wanted to give Baker Mayfield in this offense for Oklahoma, this short field.
And one play, that's one zone blitz from defensive coordinator Phil Snow of Baylor. We asked him how much they pressure Mayfield. It started on play one.
Second down and five. Mayfield pumps one way, pressured, and he throws this one away. What are we watching for here when Oklahoma has the ball?
Well, when OU has the ball, if you're Baker Mayfield, take advantage of all the weapons at your disposal and just operate efficiently. Again, going back to the top, focus on right now, right there. He threw the ball away. Great decision. As far as defensively, Clay Johnson's got to get involved, get in the backfield. He's already had 6.5 tackles for loss this year.
Third down and five, and a timeout is taken by Baylor.
Timeout.
So already, that was a big stop there on second down and five, setting up third down. And this was a key talking point with both head coach Matt Rhule and defensive coordinator Phil Snow. Third down, can they get them off the field?
And first and second down on both sides of the ball obviously predicate what third down is. And Phil Snow was saying to us, the coordinator, that they don't get in a lot of third and longs. That's just not Oklahoma's nature because they're so good. This is a pretty manageable situation for both the offense and the defense, coach.
Definitely, and they got away with one on that first play. That could have been cut back one more gap over. We'll probably take a look at that. OU will come back to that later. If he cuts that back one more step, he's gone on the first play from scrimmage.
We just saw Matt Rhule in his first year as the head coach for Baylor. There's Lincoln Riley, just 34 years old, as the first-year head coach for Oklahoma. Third down and five from the 24 of Baylor. Mayfield takes the shot, wide open, touchdown. Mark Andrews, all this guy does is catch touchdowns. 24 yards. His 16th career touchdown, second one this season.
He's recovering from a quad bruise. Does not seem to be bothering him here.
Well, this just kills you if you're Phil Snow. They rush three. They're trying to play coverage, and the corner bites on the screen. That's your guy right there, 31, jumping it. He ends up slipping up behind him for a touchdown. Great scheme. Just an itching corner trying to make a play.
Austin Seibert now on for the extra point. So Oklahoma capitalizes off that big kickoff return, getting great field position, and now Mark Andrews with that 24-yard touchdown catch. Harrison Hands, the defensive back there.
Andrews just slips in behind him. You can see right there, they're trying to play a three-deep zone, three DBs back, and that's one of the guys who's supposed to be back. So again, that kid's trying to make a play, and OU knows they're going to be jumping things early. That's a great call by Lincoln Riley to put that guy in a bind.
By the way, Coach, you said that was 29 straight
games. That's
30. Yeah, that's 30.
I'm pretty good at math. 30 out of 30, that's 100%.
Third down continues to be a problem for the Bears. They set themselves up for a pretty good situation there to force a field goal after the disastrous kickoff return. But Baker Mayfield picks them apart.
So the early score here for the Sooners. It'll be Austin Seibert to kick off with Tristan Ebner, the true freshman, back deep to return for the Baylor Bears. How does Baylor respond here? Well, Ebner won't get a chance to return this one. As Baylor takes over, what are we watching for when Baylor has the ball?
Well, they got to bounce it out on offense. We talked about them wanting to run the ball. Terrence Williams is going to play a lot. They're going to start John Lovett, probably number seven. Zach Smith, the quarterback, has just got to be a little bit more patient. He's been making better decisions, starting to direct guys around. They just have to find their balance and be calm, which is not going to be easy to do after the start that Oklahoma just had. They have momentum. There's Emmanuel Beal. This Oklahoma defense is a lot more together, according to defensive coordinator Mike Stoops, than they were last year. They can kill this Baylor confidence early and make them really doubt themselves at home.
It is Lovett in the backfield with Zach Smith starting his second game of the year. On first down, a pass that is dropped and then picked back up by Tony Nicholson.
And that's the kind of routine play Baylor has to make to stay in this game. They had a great matchup. That guy was in space, 3-on-2 on the perimeter, and just can't finish the deal. That's a great job by Zach Smith doing exactly what you talked about, Petros.
Second down and 10. Denzel Mims breaks a tackle along the sideline and is marked out at the 33-yard line. Gets 8, sets a 3rd-and-2. Emmanuel Beal, the team's leading tackler, gets his first.
They executed it that time.
Yeah, it wasn't as clean on the perimeter. It'll be interesting to see Baylor snap that ball with about 14, 15 seconds on the play clock. How much they'll milk that to try to keep Mayfield off the field.
They've struggled so far this year on third downs, facing a 3rd-and-2. Over the middle, they convert this time again to Mims. And Mims is up to the 45. Jordan Thomas with a tackle, a 13-yard completion.
It's a great job by Smith standing in there on 3rd and short, 3rd and manageable. Catches a snap, firm set, confident throw, converts it.
They really needed that first down just to calm everything down. There's a lot of Oklahoma fans in McLean Stadium tonight. They're excited to see their Sooners having a great start to the season. Baylor just needs to calm down and be steady and, like we said, find that balance.
1st and 10 as they mark it at the 46-yard line. Here's the first run, and it's Lovett. And they'll get a yard.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, you can tell right there, again, Matt Rhule's telling him to give the ball. If he would have been reading that on the backside, he could have pulled that and run to Lubbock.
This is not the kind of quarterback you want pulling the ball. He is not the mobile quarterback. Baylor's had all kinds of different quarterbacks over the years that we've seen have a lot of success. Zach Smith is big, 6'3", 225, not a runner with the football, although he can do it if he has to.
A new Solomon, who has started this year, he is out for the game. Another handoff up the middle. A good run this time by Lovett as he lowered the shoulder. Emmanuel Beal with a tackle. Picks up 7, 3rd and 2 once again.
Nice job up front by the young, inexperienced offensive line, identifying their first 3-4 defense they faced this year. And a great job finishing the run.
We saw a conversion on 3rd and 2. On a pass over the middle to Denzel Mims. What does Baylor do this time on 3rd and 2?
Let's go.
Swing it out to Lovett. Lovett trying to drive. Forward progress. It looks like he's going to be right at the line, and he does get the first down. Stephen Parker tried to stand him up, but he couldn't do it.
Now this is the kind of start that Matt Rhule wants to see from his team. They have the guy open. Lovett catches the ball on the swing pass. Very simple stuff, and just drives and wants it past 3 Sooner defenders, Stephen Parker in particular, and gets the first down. That's part of what he's trying to see from this team. That's why they do the rampage drill before the game. Some call it the Oklahoma drill.
Nicholson goes in motion. Handoff once again. And Lovett tried to change directions. Nowhere to go. He's going to lose a yard. Marquez Overton gets the tackle. How about the fact that we're just seeing this Baylor team move so much slower, actually taking time off the play clock?
Yeah, very methodical. You know, we talked to him yesterday. They don't want that ball in Six's hands too often.
That's
true. We saw how fast things happen right here. They're calling it from the sideline. The offensive coordinator, Jeff Dixon, can see the look and help out Zach Smith with the call, whether that's a run or pass protection.
Play clock down to 6. Already the 8th play of the drive coming up. Pass, dangerous pass, nearly picked by Jordan Thomas.
Pooh Strickland has got to block on the perimeter. Again, it's a numbers advantage down here to the bottom. It's going to be two Baylor Bears on one Oklahoma Sooner and one wins. That's a great job by Justin Thomas. But if you're Pooh Strickland, we used to say back in the day, no block, no rock.
Third and 12 coming up after the completion to Denzel Mims. It was for a loss of one. Play clock at three. Smith, pressure coming, throws low as he got crunched. Curtis Bolton came in, able to lay some wood on him.
There's exactly why you don't want to be in third and extra long. That's third and 13, third and 12. Very, very difficult situation for anybody, let alone Zach Smith. Drop back pass, that's not what he wants to do.
And it comes down to the play that Jordan Thomas made, the play before, really making that an unmanageable situation for Zach Smith. Good patience by Oklahoma's defense and getting Baylor off the field. Baylor's been milking the clock. It looks like Coach Helfrich's Oregon team in the fourth quarter, just sitting over that ball.
Drew Galitz on to punt. Jeff Padette back to receive. This takes an Oklahoma bounce. A nice job. Able to down that ball. But Baker Mayfield, we've seen him already in the field once. What did he do? He threw a touchdown. Baker Mayfield, a front runner for the Heisman. What will he do? His second chance on the field here at McLean Stadium. Jim Grove, the head coach last year here for Baylor, honored here in the first quarter. The interim head coach led his team to a bowl game when they beat Boise State 31-12 in the Cactus Bowl. As Baker Mayfield is back on the field, taking over at the 25-yard line. Play action on first down, pressure coming. Mayfield gets rid of it, throws towards the sideline, completes the pass to his tight end Andrews again.
And he had him open for about 5 seconds before that. That was amazing. Nobody covered Mark Andrews at all.
Yeah, he had a little stutter move right there that you can't see, and they ran a flag route as Mayfield had to flush. He saw him on a flag route. That's the rare non-touchdown by Andrews. Unbelievable percentage of touchdowns.
On first down, it's kept here by Mayfield, and Mayfield takes a hit. Let's go back to the pass by Mayfield, able to find Andrews on the sideline. Was there a hold there?
Certainly could have been. Looked like Drew Samia had a little jersey. And that's just a great, great spot and a great catch by Andrews to concentrate over the outstretched hand of that Baylor defender.
The touchdown pass on the first series, the 100th total touchdown for Baker Mayfield in his Oklahoma career. Of course, he started at Texas Tech. Throws down the middle of the field, wide open. Dimitri Flowers, Flowers to the end zone, touchdown. 52 yards. And that's now 17 straight games for Baker Mayfield with at least two touchdown passes.
Dimitri Flowers deadly in the play action pass game. That's his 10th career touchdown. And we'll take a look at this from the high angle. Here he is. He's running a drag route, which should go across the field. He says, nope, that guy's there. I'm just going to take this to the end zone. And he does. Great job by Mayfield to adjust on the run. And a great finish by Flowers.
Austin Seibert to make it 14-0. A great start for Oklahoma, not what Baylor was hoping for. Baker Mayfield, 3 of 4, 96 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 of 24 yards, and 1 of 52. And he's fired up already here in Waco.
Some beers have a lot of ingredients.
Here in Waco, it's 14-0. Sooners leading the Bears here in the first quarter. Baker Mayfield looking good so far. Couple of touchdown passes already. They've been on the field for just over 2 minutes. Austin Seibert will kick off to Tristan Ebner, standing at the goal line.
And once again, he won't get a chance to return. Time for a game break. Let's go back to L.A. and check in for the first time with Greg Wolf.
Justin, thanks. Game you can see over on Fox, number 8, Michigan. Offensive struggles continuing at Purdue, but third quarter, Chris Evans, 10-yard touchdown run gives the Wolverines their first lead of the second half. They lead 14-10 in the fourth. Justin, Petros, Mark, back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Greg. Back here, it's 14-0. Number 3, Oklahoma, not having any trouble offensively so far. Let's see what Baylor can do. We saw them try to slow the tempo down. And we'll see if we see any of Terrence Williams on this drive, although right now it's Jonathan Lovett in the backfield. Smith on first down. Smith dumps it off. A good catch is made along the sideline.
That's a great job by Zach Smith. Feel in the pocket, collapse on him, step up. He started to run, kept his eyes up, and made a play.
That was a run pass option if I ever saw one.
Pooh Strickland. He's got himself the first down. He would love to tell you who made the catch wearing number 50, but unfortunately there's no 50 on the roster.
He's out there in the slot. Looking pretty out there with that.
It's a good looking tackle.
Love it with the handoff. And he is marked out at the 42-yard line. Picks up 6.
It's a great first down gain for if you're Baylor. Keeps everything manageable. Keeps everything in the playbook as an option.
Love it really is their changeup tailback once they start getting Terrence Williams going. But like you said, Justin, we haven't seen him yet.
Love it this time, nowhere to go.
Just take a look here as this action continues. They've got number 50 lined as a wideout, and 86 has been the tackle. So we'll see if they line up in the same formation. And they just came out, and it's Jared Atkinson who's wearing that tonight. Little changeup for you, Kutch.
Usually his number is 16.
The helmet says 16. Got that going for him.
Won't be surprised if they come back to that and try to snake the tight end right down the middle.
Third down and 4 here for Baylor. Smith throws high. Good catch by Denzel Mims. Able to pull it down for the first down.
That is a big-time play by Denzel Mims, not only for his confidence, but that does a great measure for Zach Smith. Puts it where only his guy can catch it, and a great picture right there of him going up and getting it.
Denzel Mims last week had a 44-yard touchdown catch. On first down, love it. Tackled by Caleb Kelly, gets 3 yards.
And that was the first time that we saw Baylor get a big first down on the third down conversion, and they did not milk the clock. They came and snapped it right away and tried to catch the Sooners off guard with a run, and now we have a Baylor Bear down.
It's the left tackle, Maurice Porter. Able to stand up, and he's going to try to walk off under his own power. We'll take a timeout here from Waco.
Not every rivalry is a fair fight.
6'6", 310-pound senior from Missouri City, Texas. He has gone underneath the tents on the sideline to be checked out. Josh Malin has checked in for him. A handoff. Love it. Trying to cut it back. And with that cutback, able to get 4 yards. Kenneth Murray.
We take a look at the previous play. This right here may have been something missed by Zach Smith. Here's the guy we've been looking at, the eligible tackle. He runs a little arrow route with blocking up top. That's just like a bubble screen. So if Zach Smith can identify that, big yards.
Really good play by Caleb Kelly getting a hand on Jonathan Lovett. And that brings up fourth down. And they're going to go for it here from the 34-yard line.
Makes a lot of sense, right? Little wind, kind of in that dead zone.
And they bring in the right tackle, Patrick Lawrence, for Rob Sowlin, number 86, that eligible tight end, who was playing the tackle position.
Exactly.
Coach Rule's really mixing it up.
He's an old O-line. We've got to get those guys involved.
Fourth and 4. Smith throws, completes the pass. Nicholson, and Baylor converts on fourth down.
That's just a great job by both Zach Smith and the front picking up that pressure. The looper comes late right there, and that's Okoronkwo bringing it on Zach Smith. He stands in there, completes the shallow route for a huge completion.
Tony Nicholson is a guy they wanted to get more involved in the game. They needed to get him going early out of the slot, and it looks like they're accomplishing that here in the first quarter.
A nice move by Pooh. Strickland makes the first defender miss. Jordan Thomas combines the tackle with Okoronkwo. Jeff Nixon, the offensive coordinator, back there calling the plays. Hand off to Lovett. And Lovett will get a yard. Emmanuel Beal with a stop. Third and two coming up.
Here comes Terrence Williams into the game. And a whole crew now.
First time this season, Terrence Williams is on the field for Baylor. Had offseason shoulder surgery. 1,048 yards last year.
He's been anxious to get in games. Wanted to play last week against Duke. Couldn't make it happen.
They don't go to him. They swing it out wide, and it's read perfectly. Parnell Motley all over Chris Platt. The loss of one.
These aggressive corners have really helped the Sooners early, Coach.
Yeah, that's a great job by Motley. He's turned into their best cover guy, according to their staff. And right there, physical job of really running through R.J. Sneed. These receivers on the perimeter got to help each other out. There's, again, great numbers. That's a good decision by Zach Smith. It's a two-on-one. They've got to win those matchups.
It's going to be a 36-yard field goal attempt for Connor Martin. But first, a timeout taken here by Baylor. Second timeout of the half taken here by the Bears.
Their second of the half.
Oklahoma leading 14-0. Baylor trying to get on the scoreboard. In the locker room as the Baylor Bears are now looking to attempt a 36-yard field goal for Connor Martin. 2-for-2 on the season, trying to get Baylor on the scoreboard. And the kick is no good. Lincoln Riley, he's fired up. First miss of the season for Connor Martin.
Needed a timeout to get it right. They couldn't get it right.
Well, they got it right. It just wasn't good. Or they got it left, I guess. Just a tough, tough deal right here. If you're Matt Rule, you're walking up and down this sideline, looking everybody in the eye, stay the course, all that kind of stuff. You're in great position to score. Your left tackle gets hurt. Your leader of your offense, Bo Porter. Just keep banging if you're Baylor.
They have a good plan. They're pretty patient. The tight end and the fullback on the other side of the ball has absolutely destroyed this defense. They're going to have to shore that up. Once you think you got CeeDee Lamb and Jeff Badette and all these guys covered, here comes the tight end and the fullback, Andrews and Flowers, to really mess you up.
On first down, Mayfield pressure. Used the stiff arm to get away, and he completes the pass. Wow. Marquise Brown on the completion, but wow.
Exactly what we talked about in the open. Clay Johnston leading the team in tackles for losses, and he's right there. Mayfield with a nice little stiff arm. We talked about that Heisman moment. There's a little bit of a stiff arm moment.
It goes for just 3 yards, but that was impressive. And now flags are thrown.
Baylor's got 12 guys on the field. They tried.
That's one way to stop them.
Illegal substitution on the defense. 12 players in formation. 5-yard penalty remains second down.
Phil Stowe's a smart defensive coordinator. He's trying to stop with base and nickel defense simultaneously. great talking with Coach Snow yesterday. He's very fired up to be here, very excited about Coach Rule and the rebuild that's going to take place here.
A lot of teaching taking place here in Waco right now.
Marcellius Sutton in the backfield takes the handoff. He gets up to 30, and that is a first down.
Lincoln Riley almost chuckled the other day when we asked about the tailbacks, and your fourth guy is 5'9", 192-pound junior Marcellius Sutton. Expect to go the distance every time he touches the ball.
Sutton had 63 yards and a touchdown on six carries against Tulane last week. Mayfield with time, taking the shot down the field for Brown, and Brown can't bring it in. Harrison Hand there on the coverage, and that went through the hands of Marquise Brown.
Little behind him, and that's why Harrison Hand was able to make up a little bit of the distance and get that hand in there. You just see that last hesitation, but it did go through the arms.
That's a great play. Again, Coach Rule loved his toughness, a Jersey guy. A guy after Coach Rule's heart, a fellow Northeasterner. Great job, a very talented, big, and true freshman corner.
Second down and 10. Mayfield dancing around the pocket, again going deep. And this time it's too deep. Again, it's tended for Brown.
Yeah, Marquise Brown, he kind of gave up on the route. That was too bad. Baker Mayfield created a little more time for himself, and he was wide open, and he stopped.
So third and 10 coming up here for Oklahoma. Lincoln Riley, the head coach, also calling plays still here for the Sooners. And a timeout is going to be called by Oklahoma with 1:24 to go here in this first quarter.
Timeout, Oklahoma.
Oklahoma playing here on the road. They've got a 13-game winning streak. That's the longest in the nation. They've also got a 12-game road winning streak, which is the longest in FBS play, the third longest in school history. And what have they done? Well, they've only beaten six of their 12 wins against some pretty good opponents. And look at the average win. 49-25 in those true road games.
That's impressive. There's a lot of tough places to play, a lot of weather conditions to deal with in this conference. And that's very, very impressive, both by Lincoln Riley and Coach Bob Stoops, who stopped by earlier to say hi to Petros.
He didn't come say hi to me. Great standard of excellence that the Sooners have built. And it's all the way from the president to the AD to Stoops to Lincoln Riley to Mike Stoops, Kim, all these guys do a great job. There's Mike up there in the booth on the phone, listening into the broadcast.
No question.
Third down and 10. Abdul Adams back in that running back. Mayfield, he's got room to run. And Mayfield gets closed down by Clay Johnston. The team's leading tackler comes up with a big stop on third down.
Great for the confidence of the Baylor Bears defense. They have been having nothing but trouble. Finally, on this drive, after getting the blow on the sideline, they're able to close it down on third down. They've been having trouble winning there. Clay Johnson from Abilene, Texas, a sophomore, a leader, a great blitzer, makes sure he gets the hot shot quarterback down.
Seibert on to punts. Tony Nicholson back to receive it from the 24. Nicholson. There's a man down for Oklahoma. Nicholson with a big return. Nicholson gets run out by Seibert. There is a flag coming in late. Stephen Parker's the player down for Oklahoma, and it doesn't look good for him. You hate to see that. The training staff ran out to him right away.
After the play was over, personal foul, late hit out of bounds, number 11 on the kicking team. That'll be half the distance to the goal, first down Baylor.
That's against Parnell Motley.
Ellie's right there. Parker's trying to slow down to make the play. Nicholson mishandles it, and it just like it buckles on air. Just a non-contact injury sometimes, and hopefully this isn't the case. Sometimes those are the worst. That's very, very unfortunate for him. It's great to see him getting off on his own power, but when Nicholson fielded it, he kind of bobbled it, and sometimes those turn out to be the biggest returns.
Well, we talked about Baylor having to win this game if they're going to win this game or be competitive, having to do it in all three phases and needing help. Special teams was not a help to start the game. This was good. You see the left ankle there being stepped on. Parker reacted immediately. That's the starting strong safety for the Sooners defense. And here's Baylor with a great shot.
Starting at the 19-yard line now are the Bears. Terrence Williams is in at tailback. Smith stepping up over the middle. Touchdown! Denzel Mims. Four straight games, the touchdown for Mims, his fourth touchdown of the season.
Great time to go deep and respond after a big play. Zach Smith is eyeballing the safety to the field. He gets eaten up by that route. And a great job by Mims finishing the deal that time.
Connor Martin now on for the extra point. It all started with a 42-yard punt return by Tony Nicholson. A dangerous return man proved to be dangerous indeed. A penalty. Set up great field position. The first play, a 19-yard strike to Mims. And we've got ourselves a 14-7 ball game.
Mom, I just saved a lot of money on my car insurance.
They just saw Matt Rule. He did too. 14-7, Oklahoma leading Baylor with 25 seconds to go here in the opening quarter. Drew Galitz will kick off. Jeff Badette, who had the 70-yard return to open up this game, back to receive for Oklahoma. And Badette from a yard deep has some trouble, and he gets tackled at the 1-yard line. Wow, momentum shifts.
Baylor needs it in special teams, and they're getting it. And some of them are self-inflicted mistakes like that one. But Dad has to field that, but he decided to come out before he caught it.
There's a great picture. You're, as a returner, you're taught, pin those elbows together. He had his elbows apart, and it went right through the wickets. Very poor ball security right there, too.
Be at the 1-yard line with 19 seconds to go. We just saw Baylor's defense come up big on third down. Now you wonder, can they come up big and not allow Baker Mayfield and this offense to get some breathing room?
I wouldn't be surprised if they took a shot right here.
On first down, it's Adams up the middle. Abdul Adams, watch out! Abdul Adams! Trying to go 99 yards, and he does!
Now that is a long way to take it.
Was he down in touch football?
I don't think so. Right through the line of scrimmage, Baylor had everybody committed, and there was nobody in the back to get him once he broke those safeties. He was off to the races with the ability to finish the play with a lot of fast guys chasing him. Very impressive run by Abdul Adams, a sophomore out of Landover, Maryland.
He was 10 plus per carry against Tulane. I don't know what that does to the average, but it's good.
It balloons it.
Austin Seibert for the extra point. Well, Coach Elfridge, you said they were going to take a shot. I'm not sure you thought with his legs, maybe
absolutely
with the arm of Baker Mayfield.
No, that just as Petro said, it was just a great, great job of the front right there by OU Mosa. The right guard, Drew Samia, opens the lane, and Abdul Adams does the rest. Just a great response, seesaw battle right here of momentum. And OU has the upper hand right now.
Think about that. That's one of those back-breaking moments if you're Baylor. You have all the momentum. You've got them pinned down at the one. You're thinking, okay, we've got it, we've got it. First play, 99 yards from scrimmage, touchdown. Oklahoma leading Baylor. That 99-yard touchdown run is a new Oklahoma school record.
Can't be any longer, right?
Can't be any longer.
99 and a half.
Can't break that one. Can't do the Tony Dorsett 107, right? Different stats in the NFL.
To kick off again to Tristan Ebner. He's kicked two so far through the end zone. Ebner waiting to return one. They go short this time. And the flag is thrown, unable to bring it in, inbounds.
Onside kick, how about that?
That's just like Alabama in the national championship game a couple years ago. They clustered up, kind of checked out where they aligned, and tried to pooch him behind it, and that's 8 inches from being a brilliant call by Lincoln Riley.
Jordan Thomas nearly came down with it.
Free kick out of bounds on a kicking team. Ball will be placed at the out-of-bounds spot, first down.
So this is when the coaches are looking at this from the sideline, is where does this guy line up? How wide is he? Can we outflank him with the pooch? And that's really close.
Wow. Now, was that something that the kicker figured out when they lined up, or did they call it from the sideline?
They're calling that either from the booth or the sideline. So they've done that the first couple times as they kind of bunch up and cluster and then spread out. Those coaches are going to take a look at it, give them a little thumbs up, thumbs down, or whatever their signal is.
So Baylor will take over at the 45-yard line of Oklahoma. If you're looking at the bright side for Baylor, it's that you get good starting field position here after you just gave up a 99-yard touchdown run.
And Mo Porter's back in the game, their leader on offense.
Terrence Williams is in there at tailback. 5 seconds to go here in this first quarter. Williams with the carry. Williams up to the 41.
There's Williams
for four. Emmanuel Beal with a tackle, and that will do it for this first quarter of play. We saw a lot in this opening quarter. Baker Mayfield, a couple of touchdowns, a 99-yard touchdown run. Baylor with an answer. It's been fun so far. We've got three more quarters to go. Start the second quarter, Abdul Adams had that 99-yard touchdown run. We said it was the longest run in Oklahoma history. It was also the longest play from scrimmage in Oklahoma history. And you know what a 99-yard run does for your average? It helps. He's now averaging 54 yards per carry.
Give it to him more.
Williams gets the carry and picks up two.
You know, I'm surprised they waited this long to get Terrence Williams some carries. You know, here we are right at the beginning of the second quarter, and that's his second carry. I'd have thought that Coach Rule would have got him involved a little bit more to get the ball in his hand to feel it.
He was really excited to see him play. He's never seen him play live. He hasn't been able to practice with the shoulder injury.
Some confusion for Oklahoma. They give it to Williams up the middle, gets the first down. There was just, it seemed to be some late substitutions or maybe even some laziness of the guys getting on the field.
Absolutely. They have to win. The referees have to let the defense identify and adjust their personnel, but they don't have to wait for them to substitute like that. A little bit of laziness is a good call. Again, urgency this early on. Second quarter is surprising that they're having that issue.
This is Curtis Brown, who is down right now for Oklahoma, the junior.
You saw the aggression in that Williams run, that last one. Just a real difference with this guy running the ball. Once he sees where he wants to go, you see it there. He commits and gets his head down and really punishes everybody trying to tackle him. Khalil Houghton took the worst of that from him. And he's just a different level of running back for the Baylor Bears with a lot of experience.
It looked like Curtis Bolton got hit by his own man. And it may have been Kenneth Mann who got him. He has to hobble off the field. First and 10 coming up here for Baylor. From the 32-yard line of Oklahoma. Smith, pressure coming from the blind side, able to escape. Throws high, and it's nearly picked off by Jordan Thomas.
That is a great job initially by Smith here, feeling the pocket collapse. Again, as a quarterback coach, all that stuff, this is something you coach all the time. As he resets and backs out of it, that's a great job. Now keep your eyes up. Would love to see two hands on the ball and throw it away. Don't throw it to the other team.
He was trying to get it to Bruce Strickland, threw it high, and that one through the hands of Jordan Thomas. Obo was the one who got the pressure on him. He was able to escape that. And now the handoff to Williams. Terrence Williams got balled up, and now a late flag comes in.
Now that's meeting with the aggression. Kenneth Murray, the freshman, Mike Backer, hits him and might have rolled afterwards. The flag on the play.
After the play was over, personal foul, late hit, number 91 of the defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
That's Dylan Kamatau.
And that is a great job by Kenneth Murray, fitting the 1,000-yard rusher. And no question, late hit. And he's from your neck of the woods, Petros. Norwalk, California, via Cerritos College. Lincoln Riley will get in his ear on the sideline.
The guy that just hobbled off, Bolton, another Southern California guy on this Oklahoma team from Vista Murrieta.
First and 10 for the 17, Williams. We'll get a yard as Beal picks up his fifth tackle of this first half. Second down and 9. And Baylor speeding it up just a bit. Williams again. First contact made by Kenneth Mann to slow him down, and Caleb Kelly.
Sometimes you can play too fast for yourself, can't you, Coach?
No question. And they're trying to mix and match their front, that left side. They're trying to figure out it on Baylor and Matt Rhule there. Xavier Newman, a true freshman from DeSoto, Texas, making his first start. That was him at left guard, having some issues.
See the offense so different. Matt Rhule again told us an emphasis on running the football. Third and 7. And now the third timeout of the half is being called here by Matt Rhule. Confusion offensively for Baylor. Third and 7 coming up. And Matt Rhule is forced to take the timeout deep in Oklahoma territory. What that place is. Matt Rhule called the timeout. 29 total plays, 20 of them coming in Oklahoma territory, facing a 3rd and 7 from the 15-yard line. Pressure coming. Smith to the point of the end zone. Incomplete. Mims could not get a foot down inbounds.
Good idea. Mims reacted quickly to that back shoulder throw.
Yeah, that's again a really good spot. If you're Zach Smith, that's almost everything you could do. Mims just has to sink his hips and be able to slow down a little more quickly. That's 6 inches from being right back in this thing. Maybe 2 feet. But optimistic.
They might take a look at it. Maybe his left foot or toe was down when the ball hit his hands. Wasn't secure at that point, I'm not sure, but at least enough to look at it. Look at that left foot.
Brad Van Vark is our referee. David Ames is our replay official.
Did it come up before the ball showed up? It looked like it did.
Yeah, I think he's just in the air as he truly controls it. There, he's off the ground.
Yeah.
It was 6 inches. That was close. Just on the wrong foot.
Let's bring in Dean Blandino from LA right now and get Dean your thoughts on this call here.
This is close. They're looking at that back foot, the left foot. You have to establish when does he get control and then where is that foot? Is it touching the ground? Looks like it's just
after
coming
the review,
off the ground. This call should stand.
The ruling on the field of an incomplete pass is confirmed.
You are correct.
Bingo, Dean.
One for one.
Exactly what all three of you guys were saying. So close, but it doesn't count. Instead, it's a 32-yard field goal attempt now for Connor Martin, who missed from 36 earlier. He missed from the opposite hash mark.
All these kick situations, if you're Matt Rule, this could be a time to fake one. OU has to know that as well and constantly communicate that on defense.
And this time, the kick is good. From 32 yards. Number 3, Oklahoma against 0-3 Baylor. Here in the second quarter, it's 21-10 Oklahoma.
I want you to take it easy. Go
San Oklahoma leading Baylor, and Allstate is proud to be part of the team that comes together to do good by contributing to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kicked. To date, Allstate has contributed millions in scholarship funds. Marcellus Sutton to return. And he gets tackles as he crossed the 20. Up the 23-yard line, time for a game break. Let's go back to L.A. and talk to Greg Wolf.
Justin, thanks. We have a final in Stillwater between number 16 TCU and 6th-ranked Oklahoma State. It was a one-score game late fourth until Darius Anderson takes off. They are 4-0. Oklahoma gets them November 11th. Back to you guys.
Yeah, guys, and so much was made about Oklahoma, Oklahoma State this year, Bedlam. All of a sudden, TCU just put a little wrinkle in that whole matchup.
People forgot Gary Patterson can coach.
Jeff Badette was out as a kickoff return on the last one. He's back in on offense, so they haven't completely fired him.
High snap, handoff to Adams, who took it 99 yards to the house on his last carry. And see, things just even out.
That'll hurt his average.
Yards and no yards.
That'll hurt. Ultimately, Baylor's offense has been okay in this game. They've done a good job of executing their plan, getting the ball out to the perimeter, getting the quarterback more confident. Defensively, they've had some trouble. Let's see what they can do in this drive.
Baker Mayfield on second down and 10. Pumps, takes the shot down the field. Bobbled and brought down. CeeDee Lamb. The true freshman all the way down to 31, a 47-yard completion.
Well, that's a perfect ball by Baker Mayfield to CeeDee Lamb. He just kind of makes it difficult. It's a good job trying to rake it out there by Graylin Arnold. Just this is his first game action of the year. And then CeeDee looking like Didi as he finishes that play.
Didi Westbrook, of course, the reference. CeeDee. He's making a name for himself early on here for Oklahoma. Just like that. Switch field position. And the handoff to Adams. Again, no gain.
Phil Snow, the defensive coordinator from Baylor, that, he just played the same defense on that snap, and that's why he's doing it. They've got to stop the run and it just be good enough to hold up in man coverage. That's easier said than done against this talented group and number 6.
Early they were hurt by the tight end and fullback. Now the wide receivers are starting to get it. And a
It all comes from Mayfield, doesn't it?
Baker Mayfield, 147 yards so far. Pressure coming. Mayfield takes a big hit and still completes the pass to Mark Andrews.
That is an all-out, no deep, zero blitz by Baylor. Man-to-man all the way across. He finds his guy, Andrews, and that's a big-time play by Mayfield.
It's Taylor Young that comes and hits him, Coach. You see him clean up Mayfield there. Clean hit right under the arm. Mayfield takes it down for a second, but pops back up. And, of course, the tight end that would hurt him early hurts him again, Mark Andrews.
Andrews, first-team All-Big 12 last year. When he caught seven touchdowns, he's got a touchdown here already tonight.
And that was against Teyon Sells. This is his first action. He was suspended for the first three games of the season.
Oklahoma, their second of the half. It'll be 30 seconds in duration.
Just the zero blitz pressure, no safeties is what the zero means. A great clean hit, as you said, Petros. And there's the man-to-man matchup you have to win if you're Oklahoma. And if you're Teyon Sells for Baylor, you got to rip that thing out. Mark Andrews, they do a great job with all these tight ends, H-back, Dimitri Flowers, Mark Andrews already with touchdowns tonight. They do a great job of getting them in matchups, and that's a great example right there.
Three catches, 72 yards for Mark Andrews already here in this game. Mark Andrews, a guy who has type 1 diabetes, has to check his blood level every quarter.
Mayfield in motion.
Dimitri Flowers, the Wildcat. Flowers takes a knock and he reaches for the end zone for the touchdown. We saw Dimitri Flowers earlier catch one for a touchdown. Now he runs one in for a touchdown from 3 yards out.
Kind of a slow developing fullback Wildcat play.
Yeah, Baker Mayfield, who we don't see here going in motion, he goes out in motion. They give it to 6'2", 249-pound Dimitri Flowers, and he finishes right over the top of Drew Samia. That's his guard there. Help me into the end zone.
Austin Seibert on for the extra point.
Yeah, they're trying to clarify here whether or not he broke the plane. And he goes over the top of his own guy there and definitely breaks the plane, and they just confirmed it.
Flowers with the touchdown run, but it was all set up. Baker Mayfield able to find CeeDee Lamb, little bobble, able to corral it, bring it down, and then after taking the hits, Mark Andrews and Dimitri Flowers in the Wildcat formation over the top of his guard. It's 28-10 Oklahoma here in the second quarter.
Coney Island has been around for a long time.
Leading here in the second quarter, Baker Mayfield engineering another scoring drive. CeeDee Lamb, that 47-yard completion. Five plays, 78 yards. Dimitri Flowers ran it in from 3 yards out. But that was the first drive that took over 2 minutes. Austin Seibert. No return here for Tristan Ebner. Well, coming up next, college football continues here on FS1 as the seventh-ranked Washington Huskies battle Colorado. College football on FS1, where every game is everything. Guys, how about Oklahoma? Already five passes of 20-plus yards today.
personality of this quarterback.
No question. He looks for the deep ball, and this defense sets that up. There's a lot of one-on-one matchups, and there's a lot of X's for Oklahoma that you would pick over the Baylor O at this point in this program's development. The key also, Oklahoma, two third downs so far. They've had two third downs. That means you're doing a great job on first and second down and staying out of third down.
That play clock is down to three. They just do get it off. A nice cut move there by Nicholson. Stopping on a dime. Khalil Houghton with a tackle, a pickup of six.
He just froze him right there in the slot. Nicholson getting more action today. They're doing a good job getting the ball to the perimeter, making these Oklahoma corners, who are very aggressive, be aggressive. We'll see if they can exploit that later down the field.
Second down at four. In the backfield, Jonathan Lovett gets wrapped up, a loss of two. Devontae Lampkin returning today. Did not play against UTEP, and Tulane was in there. Third down and six here for Baylor. Smith airing it out down the sideline. Completes the pass to Mims. Mims to the end zone. Touchdown, 71 yards.
Great job all around here. First offensive coordinator Jeff Nixon freezing the play call, getting in the right deal, and finding their one-on-one matchup, which is speed on speed here. Mims against Thomas. Great job staying in bounds. So many guys you see fall out of bounds, and it's just a 30-yard gain. There, those are the types of plays Baylor has to make and turn them into touchdowns to stay in this fight.
Talked about the corners being a little too aggressive. Thomas seemed like he was just waiting for him, and Mims ran right by him. He never even touched him, never got a hand on him, jammed him, nothing.
Second touchdown of the game for Denzel Mims. Connor Martin on for the extra point. The Baylor Bears showing some fight. That's old school Baylor right there. A quick strike right back. 71 yards to Denzel Mims down the sideline on third down. And Zach Smith, celebration.
Join
for Oklahoma here over Baylor. 8:48 to go in this first half. Denzel Mims, 128 yards, 71 of those 128 coming on that touchdown catch. 11 of the 12 touchdowns this year for Baylor have come quickly. Marcellus Sutton again back to receive here for Oklahoma from the one. And Sutton breaks some tackles. Flag is thrown as he gets tackled at the 30. Let's wait to see what this flag is for. Our referee, Brad Van Vark.
During the return, holding number 87 of the receiving team, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
That's against Miles Tease as we go back to the touchdown pass to Denzel Mims.
It's a great job by the whole offensive staff. They have the sideline and find the matchup. It's man free. There's no help for that guy up top. Zach Smith puts it in a perfect location for Denzel Mims. And then he does the rest over the top of Jordan Thomas.
Yeah, he really tight-roped it there.
Oklahoma starting now at their own 20. Marcellus Sutton in the backfield. Hand off to Sutton up the middle. Clay Johnston meets him. A pickup of a couple yards. Second tackle of the game for Clay Johnston.
Now, can defensive coordinator Phil Snow find something here to get Baker Mayfield uncomfortable?
Force a third down. They're showing field pressure. Somebody from the top side of the formation might be coming here. There they come. The pass to CeeDee Lamb, and CeeDee Lamb is able to break that tackle and get the first down.
Baker Mayfield saw the same thing. When you bring a pressure from the field, usually the boundary flat, the area closest to the sideline, 0 to about 10 yards, is wide open. Found Lamb for a big game.
13-yard pickup. CeeDee Lamb, 2 catches, 60 yards in this game.
And now you see the boundary is the near side of the field for Baker Mayfield. He's got the other side to work with.
Play action. Mayfield, pressure. Mayfield gets hit. Sacked by Taylor Young. Taylor Young was the one who delivered the hit on the completion to Mark Andrews. Chris Miller was the one who applied the initial pressure.
The old Will linebacker, helmet to the sternum, will take some confidence away from you. Two guys for Dimitri Flowers to block, and he decides to go out on a route. And Mayfield, well, he gets hit by both of them.
Yeah, Taylor Young does a great job, but Chris Miller is the guy who kind of funnels him back inside. Looked like Taylor Young was kind of in containment mode there when Baker broke contain, and he triggered.
A loss of 6 on the play. Play clock down to 3. Mayfield. The completion to Marquise Brown.
That was basically a screen all the way. You can see the shallow route coming. All the receivers to the top side of the field, the three-man side of the field, were all blocking. They were all engaged.
That was the CeeDee Lamb, excuse me.
Mayfield certainly distributes it to everybody who's eligible out there.
3rd and 8. Just the third down of the game for Oklahoma. Hand off to Sutton. And Sutton gets stuffed. Clay Johnston, the first one there.
Great answer by defensive coordinator Phil Snow and the Baylor Bears. Some OU fans might be disappointed in that call. That's a great call into this defense. It turns into a 5-man pressure. And if they fit that perfectly, it's one of those things they cut through for a home run, or they can turn it to almost essentially a sack and bring up 4th down.
Clay Johnson, number 44, really did a great job jumping in the gap for Phil Snow's defense there, the defensive coordinator. And he's got something to celebrate on the sideline with his guys, forcing a punt. 2nd one of the game.
Trevor White. Fair catch signals is made by Tony Nicholson. 46-yard punt. The Baylor Bears, really prior to last October, from the start of 2011, were one of the best teams in the country. Look at the company they share. And then, after October 15th of 2016, look at what's happened. 1-9. Owen 3 to start this year. Matt Rhule, he said he felt like Baylor was going to allow him to do it right, to build this team and this program the right way. Williams on the carry. It's the reason why Rhule wanted to come here to Baylor, because he knew, you know what, if we have a rough season, the administration, everybody, they're going to be patient with him.
Yeah, I thought he was very honest and very real in his approach to this whole thing. This is a staff with 37 years of NFL experience or something like that. These guys know how to coach. It's going to take a while. Totally different style.
A little shovel pass to Nicholson. Nicholson trying to get to the edge. Stiff arm against Stephen Parker. Good to see Parker back in there.
We talked to Coach about all the new players and all the teaching going on. 31 new players in this Baylor program this year. They'll sign 24 new ones, give or take, in the new class. So everybody's different here at Baylor. There's no doubt about it.
3rd and 5 coming up. Oh, with time. Over the middle, wide open, Chris Platt. Platt's got that blazing speed. He's got the first down, up to the 43, picks up 18.
Nice execution there by Baylor. You can see the receivers move closer toward the ball. The whole formation squeezed down. A lot of times that'll bring up shallow routes, shallow crossers. Zach Smith does a great job getting through his progression and finding the speedster Platt for a big conversion.
What's your take on what you've seen so far from Zach Smith?
He's done a great job. You look at his line right now, he's 14 of 17, 174 and two. And in that three incompletions were two drops. So he's doing a really good job. I think they could still help him out with how they're matching up the run and the pass.
Well, they run here with Terrence Williams. And Williams gets no yards, tackled by Kenneth Murray, the true freshman middle linebacker.
Now, the Bears are up against the powerhouse in Oklahoma. There's no doubt about that. But one of the things that Coach Rhule talked about coming into this game was third down and winning on third down on the defensive side and the offensive side. You just saw it. They stopped Oklahoma on a third down. Interesting play call with the run, but they stopped them, forced a punt, and they just converted a third down here. That's good stuff to take into the locker room.
Yeah, you're going to get the ball first. If they get anything positive out of this drive, it's huge. And that's not going to help when Rob Solin jumps offside.
Ball start. Offense, number 86. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
That's just the third penalty in this first half against Baylor. Think about it, they were penalized 10 times in the first half last week against Duke.
Yeah, big point of emphasis for them. They went from 10 in the first half to 1 in the second half, but that one's costly there. It takes you out of second and 10. Second and 15 is not where they want to operate.
Nicholson in motion. Smith to Platt. Platt can't slip the tackle by Parnell Motley.
I like Motley's physicality. That guy can cover. You love those corners that can cover and then find themselves in the backfield and get guys on the ground.
We saw Jordan Thomas beat a little bit earlier in the game, but that is really one of the differences for Coach Mike Stoops' defense this year, the defensive coordinator for the Sooners. The corners have been much more consistent. Motley and Thomas have really helped him out, especially against Ohio State. They were huge in that game.
Here's Coach Stoops' defensive coordinator. Motley had the pick six against Tulane.
Went 77 yards on third and 12. Pressure coming. Smith can't get rid of it. He gets sacked. Taken down by Kenneth Mann. His second sack of the season, a loss of 7 on the play.
Great job by Mann, just staying active again. An inexperienced guy there, 55 Xavier Newman for Baylor is a freshman going up against this OU front is a rude awakening in his first Big 12 start.
Drew Galitz on to punt. C.D. Lamb back to receive, standing around his own 25. And a flag.
Ball start on the offense. All 11 players never got set. 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Again, just another pre-snap administrative penalty that hurts Baylor. Matt Rhule would take a all square right here going at halftime. Keep it 28-17. OU has one timeout to operate if they get it back.
140 feels like a year for Baker Mayfield to operate with all the weapons he has and utilizes.
Two-time all Big 12 punter as Galitz gets off a good one. Lamb back at his own 18. And Lamb, good coverage, 55-yard punt. McVay with the tackle on special teams. Let's check in with Rob Stone to find out what's going to happen coming up at the half.
Coming up on the State Farm halftime, new quarterback. Same problems for Florida State. The Noles in a place they haven't been in since 1989. Plus, we're going to look ahead to our Pac-12 championship rematch, which follows your game in Waco. Justin Petros, coach, we'll see you at the half.
All right, thanks, Rob. Looking forward to that. Baker Mayfield with 128 to go. Mayfield, 8 of 11, 196 yards, 2 touchdowns so far. One timeout remaining for Oklahoma, and they'll start at the 21-yard line. Mayfield is going to run on first down. And Mayfield finally gets taken down by Clay Johnston, but picks up the first down, gets 11 yards.
He doesn't run the ball like a Heisman candidate quarterback who needs to stay healthy throughout the year. He puts moves on people, goes downfield. He's a lot thicker than I thought he was when we went down and saw him before the game. He looks a little bit like a running back, a little bit.
Mayfield towards the sideline. And he completes that pass to Marquise Brown.
Great operation there by Baker Mayfield. They were trying to get a double move on the safety right down the middle by Bidette. That was covered. Went to his outlet up top, Marquise Brown, and got out of bounds.
You almost get the sense watching Baker Mayfield right here that he relishes this right now. Getting the ball with 1:28 to go, it's like, all right, now it's my time. Second down and four. Pressure coming up the middle. Mayfield trying to escape. He can't. Sacked by Taylor Young, the second of the game for Young.
Just again, great effort by Taylor Young. And just like you said, a competitive guy wants the rock. And the competitive guy sometimes wants to hold on to it too long. He's got to escape, trying to throw it away right there. Possible face mask there laid on Ira Lewis. Got away with that one. Lincoln Riley electing not to use his timeout right now. It's third and long.
Taylor Young's gotten a few good hits on Baker Mayfield. Baker broke his tackle on the previous play on the scramble. That time, couldn't do it.
Third and 13. Mayfield throws, and it's nearly picked off in the hands of Tayon Sells. And that would have been the first interception of the season for Baker Mayfield.
And that would have been a touchdown. Tayon Sells, I think he was thinking that as he tried to headbutt the ball there. But if he catches this ball, he's gone. Baker Mayfield tries to force one late. Sells does a great job triggering on it. He's going to run a long way down the right sideline. There was nobody there. Mayfield just didn't see him.
Baker Mayfield hasn't thrown an interception in 146 attempts. Nicholson from his 20. A 51-yard punt by Seibert. And that's going to do it here for the first half. The fans here at McLane Stadium, they appreciate the effort by the Baylor Bears. But number three, Oklahoma, leading 28-17 here at the half. Coming up, it's a State Farm halftime show with Rob Stone, Dave Wonstadt, Robert Smith, and Matt Leinart. That's all coming up. Atlas commercial break. A good first half from football here in Waco, the first game of the Big 12 season for these two teams. Just kidding, you thought you were going to get Rob Stone and the gang, right? Ha ha, there's actually 3 seconds to go here in this half, and now...
I've always wanted to be Matt Leinart. Can I pretend to be Leinart?
If I can be Robert Smith from The Cure.
Now Rob Stone and the guys will be coming up after the break with a State Farm halftime show. It's 28-17 at the half here in Waco, Oklahoma leading. Texas, Baylor, and Oklahoma as we get set to start the third quarter, 28-17. The Sooners lead the Bears, with the Bears receiving the second half kickoff. Justin Kutcher alongside Petros Papadakis and Mark Helfrich. And Petros, a lot of people talk about this Oklahoma offense, and for good reason. They score 28 points in that first half. However, give credit to that Baylor defense for holding them to just 28 points.
Oh, they've been scrappy. They've done exactly what Coach Rule wants them to do, led by an upperclassman in Taylor Young, the linebacker who's been getting after Baker Mayfield. They've made Oklahoma earn it, but Oklahoma has earned it with some really big plays, Coach.
No question. We talked about high-impact efficiency up front. Here's Badette starting the day off with a huge kickoff return. Leads to a touchdown by Mark Andrews, the touchdown scoring machine tight end. Baker Mayfield to Andrews. That's followed up by Dimitri Flowers. And a big throw and catch and finish by Flowers. Abdul Adams then tries to get on the action with a 99-yard touchdown run. This all adds up to 26 plays and leading to 28 points for OU's explosive offense. Six plays over 20-plus yards.
So you're saying that's pretty good efficiency for Oklahoma. 312 yards in that first half. You mentioned those six plays of 20-plus yards. For Baylor, it was Denzel Mims. A couple of touchdowns, 128 yards in that first half. And no chance to return here once again for Treston Ebner from Austin-Seibert. But Baylor will start at the 25-yard line. Zach Smith. We talk so much about Baker Mayfield. And Coach Helfrich, I asked you your thoughts on Zach Smith during that first half. He had just three incompletions in the first half.
Yeah, he's doing a nice job. And again, credit him and credit this offensive staff for kind of figuring out who they are. Built into that high efficiency there, a couple fly sweep tosses, bubble screens, all that stuff to kind of get his confidence going and get this offense moving.
Terrence Williams starts in the backfield here for Baylor to open up the third quarter. And he takes the handoff on first down, reaches forward, and he'll pick up 4 yards up to the 29. Caleb Kelly with a tackle.
We're going to see what they give to Williams here in the second half. A little bit sparse with him early in the game. Didn't really start getting going until the second quarter. Coach Rule's going to have to depend on him later in this game. He is their most confident and proven running back.
9 carries, 23 yards on the game so far for Williams. Smith, with time, taking a shot, has a man open, it's Platt. Platt can fly. Touchdown Baylor, 72 yards.
Smith is gaining confidence with every throw.
Yeah, just again, great scheme there. They had a bunch concept, three receivers close together. Oklahoma tries to match it with man coverage. One guy gets rubbed off, and it's a touchdown. Looks like the Bears going to go for two here early on in the second half.
Does it surprise you going for two right now, this early?
It does and it doesn't. You know, go with the momentum. It makes it a clean score as far as being down three. Instead of down four, you're used to being down four. The book, quote unquote, says to wait to the fourth quarter. I haven't read that book. But a lot of times when you line up like this, you're going to see what they're doing. Shift, move around. If you get a delay of game, you can still kick. Right now, there's 10 on the play clock, so they got to get it rolling.
Smith rolling out to his right. Doesn't have much, and he finds something, and he finds Nicholson for a two-point conversion. It is a three-point game just like that.
Dream start here for Zach Smith and Coach Rule, getting it rolling, getting the crowd back into it. Man free again. Oklahoma's playing a lot of man coverage, and you can't see it out there, but they mismatched the rub, essentially. That means Jordan Thomas was trying to switch off to get to Chris Platt, and he couldn't. Here's the route. He's hesitated. You can't see him do that. He should have just stayed on the outside receiver and kind of matched the route. And Chris Platt is too fast.
Second time Jordan Thomas has been beat deep, once by Platt and once by Mims. And Nicholson Mickelson has been very effective as the inside receiver. These three guys are getting it going, and Pooh Strickland too for Zach Smith. They're starting to find some confidence within that group, but that is a veteran group for this team. They don't have a lot of that for Coach Rule.
Exactly, and Jordan Thomas, he's their most experienced guy. He's their most physical guy. They took advantage of his aggressiveness.
Chris Platt had touchdown catches of 73 and 79 yards last week against Duke. Goes for 72 here to open up the third quarter. Marcellius Sutton from a yard deep. He will try to return it. And Sutton with a good return. Finally gets run out of bounds at the 40-yard line by the kicker, Drew Galitz.
That kid is impressive, Sutton. You can see why they like him again. 10-plus yards per carry in the Tulane game. He kind of hesitation dribbles right there. It breaks through. That's just a great chair cut. That looked like Papadakis back in the day.
Yeah, I didn't have that one. But I tell you what, I think his hesitation in the end zone kind of froze the Baylor kickoff team. They thought he was going to take a knee and not have to hit anybody. And all of a sudden, here he comes.
Well, here comes Baker Mayfield, who went over 200 yards in that opening half. On first down, the handoff to Abdul Adams, and a flag is thrown. Adams gets tripped up, will pick up 9 yards, but let's wait to see what this flag is for.
Holding, offense, number 71. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay first down.
We got Bobby Evans, the redshirt sophomore, at a tackle.
Yeah, he started 15 games straight. Allen High School in Texas, a premier program. Just gets his hands just outside. Somebody's got to account for Taylor Young. The guy's been making plays all over the field.
So instead of a run of 9 yards, backs him up 10, first and 20. Hand off again. Maybe a yard. Taylor Young. He got held last time. Nobody held him this time. He makes a tackle. The Sooners, they were bundled up. They weren't going for a big play.
Yeah, that's one of those stats defensive coordinators like to point to, but unfortunately they have 28 points out of those other ones. Really sound on that last play by their defense. Everybody was matched up, accounted for the quarterback, accounted for the deep ball. Second and 20. Dropping an 8.
Mayfield, design quarterback run. Mayfield able to get outside and is chased out of bounds at the 43-yard line.
The clock in his head is so slow. This guy is so poised out there. He's so calm, and he runs the football with such patience, but he does have a good burst of speed.
He really does, and he's a lot stronger than you give him credit for. Like you said in pregame, he's at least 225.
After a 13-yard run, they're facing 3rd and 7. Oklahoma 1 of 4 on third down in this game. Mayfield towards the sideline, incomplete. CeeDee Lamb could not come down with it.
Harrison Hand, that's our New Jersey kid. Another great play by him. Really good spot by Baker Mayfield. Harrison Hand just physical on the top of it. And knocks it away from Land. Great fit, clean. That's textbook defensive back play right there by Harrison Hand.
And not bad for Lincoln Riley. I mean, that's exactly what they wanted. CeeDee Lamb and his height going up, and the ball was there. Just a superior play by the corner.
Tony Nicholson back deep. Austin Seibert to punt. A booming punt here. And this will go into the end zone. The Baylor Bears, 0-3 on the season. Opening up Big 12 play against the third-ranked team in the country, and they trail by just 3. They're rocking here at McLean Stadium. 3-point game, Oklahoma. How about this? As the third-ranked team in the last 10 years, 7 losses. Doesn't seem to make any sense. Oh. Baylor, 4 straight home wins against top 10 opponents. And it's a three-point game here in the third quarter. A little shovel pass to Chris Platt with that speed. Platt, you can see him nearly about to break it. Now Platt is down on the ground, clutching his leg.
Elite 400 runner. Really has a stride that seems to kind of fly off the field, and he's trying to work out that leg, getting that stride going again.
He's a tough track guy. I love those tough track guys. Some guys are like Maseratis and they can't get hit, but he's a tough dude. Oklahoma does a great job of fitting every gap here. You can see all the white shirts running to chase him down. Hopefully that's just a little tweak and he's going to be fine. Great job running there. 14 Beal pacing him, not overrunning the play, letting him cut vertically, and a really good finish on the perimeter by Beal.
The All-American, the 4x400-meter relay, trying to get loose along the sidelines. On second and nine, a bobble by Smith. Broken play, just throws it away. Good heads-up play there by Zach Smith.
Is that supposed to go to the running back?
Well, it looks to me like they're telling him what to do. They're telling him pre-snap whether to throw the bubble screen or hand the ball off. He just bobbled this one, and if you're bobbling the exchange like this, which this was probably supposed to be a predetermined give, he kind of panics and throws it away. He could have thrown the bubble screen up top. They still had numbers.
Third and nine. Another third down conversion.
Great rhythm there by Zach Smith. You see him up stop. Mims again pushes him off with that great speed. Drops his hips. Comes out of it right at the chains. Good knife again. Jordan Thomas.
They're picking
on
him
from Klein. He's getting worked out.
142 yards on the game so far. Hand off to Lovett. Lovett's got a hole. And Lovett gets shoved out of bounds at the 46-yard line. A 19-yard run. Khalil Halton finally shoves him out.
And now John Lovett, with the emergence of Terrence Williams back from an injury, can be that change of pace back. They bring him across the formation. Nice blocking from Denzel Mims down the field. And Baylor's got it going offensively. Oklahoma's defense is starting to fatigue, which is a very interesting thing. We did not think we would see that scenario.
Love it again. A good run on first down, gets three.
Got to give Xavier Newman some love here, too. The true freshman had some issues early on these last two runs. His block at the point of attack, the left guard, has been key.
Now, Coach Mike Stoops and his defense starting to look for some answers against Zach Smith, who's gaining in confidence. And you can see Coach Stoops is gaining in frustration up in the booth. Does Oklahoma have to adjust their play calling when they get the ball back to rest their defense?
Second down and six. It's kept by Smith. He just dives, knowing he was going to get hit as he crossed the 40 to 39. Emmanuel Beal and Okoronkwo combined for the tackle.
Sometimes the dive is better than the slide.
Exactly. They're stopping it for something here. Not sure if it's blood or a helmet.
It's Jordan Thomas. Whatever it is, he's got to leave the game. Trey Norwood comes in.
Yeah, Zach Smith there building some confidence. That pull was an aggressive move by him, putting his left foot in the ground and going north.
Do you go after Norwood right here? He just walked off the sideline cold.
They've got their speedster up top again, Denzel Mims. Third and medium here. This could be a four-down scenario. This is a time where the Baylor offensive staff is talking about, is this a two-play situation? Should we run the ball first? Or they could take a shot like Petro said. It's going to turn into man coverage again. Single high, man free. There goes the free safety.
Third and three, Smith looking over to the sideline.
Tom Petros
You called it right at Trey Norwood. Another third down conversion. They're now 8 of 13 on third down as that went for 11.
Yeah, they got Thomas right back in there, but just a great push. Love to see him keep his hips down as he accelerates through there, but he lets the true freshman know he'll be back.
Yeah, gives him a little something on the chin strap. This Baylor team is getting more and more physical and starting to stand up to the big bully.
Smith with time. Towards the end zone, incomplete, looking for Chris Platt. Parnell Motley there on the coverage.
Looked like Motley had a hip a little bit that turned Platt, but not enough contact for the ref to draw the flag.
Yeah, it looked like he was trying to hook him, and they probably let that go as an uncatchable situation. Good job by John Lovett there in protection, the true freshman tailback. We said that a lot for Baylor. True freshman, freshman, true freshman, freshman. Good job by Lovett in pass protection on a blitzing backer.
35 of 66 starters in the first three games have been freshmen or sophomores for Baylor this year. Shuttle pass to Nicholson. Nicholson making a couple of moves, and that's a good open field tackle by Stephen Parker. Good 4-yard pickup.
Really good fit by Parker. Again, the Baylor offensive staff utilizing their weapons. Put that ball away, big fella. Great closeout right there. That's the preseason all Big 12 returner in space. That's all Baylor can ask for.
Big third down here.
Third and six from the 24 in a 3-point game. 8 of 13 on third down conversions. And it's dropped by Lovett, wide open. Had the touchdown if he catches it.
Yeah, got away with one there. That's, again, the long foul ball. The true freshman just did a great job in pass protection. Could have got his name in big lights right here. Oklahoma busts the coverage. They're bringing two guys off the edge, and nobody peels off or accounts for the tailback out of the backfield. Great job by Zach Smith recognizing it. Got to go love that kid up and hope he makes a play another day.
You need him for the rest of this game.
Absolutely.
Got to get his confidence back. Just a true freshman. Unfortunate for Baylor. Very fortunate for the Sooners.
Connor Martin from 41 to tie it up. And Connor Martin does just that. The Baylor Bears shocking just about everyone right now against the third-ranked team in the country. All tied up, having scored 18 straight points. Matt Rhule looking for his first win. It would be a big one.
Introducing Wendy's new giant junior bacon.
Do not adjust your TV screen. That score is correct. 28-28 Oklahoma and Baylor with 8:22 to go here in this third quarter. Baker Mayfield itching to get back on the field. Drew Galitz to kick off here for the Bears. Marcellius Sutton back to return. Jeff Badette had that big return to open the game, but he bobbled one. Left his team at the one. He has not been there to return since, and now Sutton. He will take in the end zone. Well, it's turning into quite the day and night here in the top 10 as we take a look at what has transpired so far today and tonight. Oklahoma State lost at home against TCU 37-31. Obviously, what's going on right now here in Waco.
And Washington, Colorado after us is going to be a lot of fun to watch. That's coming up later on, right here on FS1. I got to say, these conference games are different. And when people were saying, Oklahoma's going down to Baylor, Baylor lost to Liberty, they're done. Conference games are different. These teams know each other, not necessarily bad blood, but familiar blood, recruiting blood. And Coach Rhule has got his team ready to go. They could have wilted in the first quarter when they went down. They have not.
On first down, hand off to Sutton. And Marcellius Sutton got tackled by Taylor Young, a pickup of three. Taylor Young just grabbed the shoe, and now the guys are getting into it. Things are getting chippy. They've been chippy since pregame.
They were chippy before the game. They were chippy last night on Instagram. They've been chippy for a while here, and it's starting to happen to where Baylor is making the more physical plays. Guys that are going down on the back of their jerseys and the back of their heads are Oklahoma guys.
Second down and 7.
Guess who?
I'm going to say Young.
Taylor Young. Great fit and finish there. Love to see Matt Rule pulled his guy out off the previous play who was starting the issue. Got into him on the sideline. Now he's loving him up again. It was Jamie Jacobs, a backup defensive end linebacker. Big third down to see what Phil Snow has for him on defense.
Look at this place right now. Abdul Adams in on 3rd and 7. It is Adams with a blocker. Adams slips a tackle, has the first down. Adams had that 99-yard touchdown run in the first half, and he picks up 13 on a big third down.
Run blitz on the wrong side, right?
Well, that's a zone pressure. There's a lot of guys coming from the offensive left side, defensive right side, and Adams is perfectly fit with that zone play.
Again, a nice tackle by Teyon Sells. Eight-yard run, though.
Yeah, going back on that third down, so many defensive coordinators dial up those pressures against the pass, and they forget that it is legal to run the ball on third down. And a great kind of chess match there between Coach Riley and Phil Snow, the defensive coordinator for Baylor.
Second down and 2 coming up. Don't forget, this is Lincoln Riley's first Big 12 game as a head coach as well. Adams, flags are thrown everywhere.
Right guard, Drew Samia was out there leading through.
Yeah, he was just doing a great job finishing the guy.
Holding. Offense number 75.
That's a tough
10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay second down.
Watch him here. He just has his guy on skates. He's the right guard here for Oklahoma. Gets to the second level. Initially, he has his hands inside of Chris Miller, but he just doesn't let him off.
The Sooners matching some physicality here. That was a bit of a mismatch.
That's 302 on 185.
Second down and 6. Empty backfield here for Mayfield. Gets rid of it quickly to Adams. And Adams makes the catch and has enough for that first down. Braylon Arnold with the tackle, but a pickup of 7.
Abdul Adams here showing his versatility. Coach Riley told us early in the week he wasn't quite sure what all these guys could do. By my observation, Abdul Adams could do it all.
Yeah. 125 yards on the ground, 99 of those coming on that touchdown run. Into Baylor territory once again. Mayfield completes the pass to Marquise Brown. Brown loses the ball. Recovered by Baylor. Chris Miller recovers it.
Nice play action. Wide open was Brown. He came back for the ball. And Baylor just so active with their hands defensively. Let's look at that knee. Ah, that ball's out.
Teyon Sells forced the fumble, and Chris Miller recovered it. A chance for the Baylor Bears to take the lead as they will get the ball when we come back in a tie ball game, 28-all. One, 28-28, the Big 12 opener for number 3, Oklahoma and Baylor on first down. The handoff is to Williams. And Williams will get a couple of yards.
Look like Lampkin. Creating a pile in there. Coach Mike Stoops very excited to have him back.
Some big boys up there in the Oklahoma defensive front. They outweigh this Baylor offensive line by a lot.
Second down and eight. The question is, what can Baylor do off that turnover? Williams made a stutter step.
Inside zone, you'd love to see the tailback stay square, put his right foot in the ground and go north, just like we saw him do earlier. That's not his game, bouncing it outside like that.
Facing a third and six. It's a big, big moment right now for Oklahoma, trying to pick up the offense of the turnover. Smith with time, open receiver, caught. Who's Strickland? Strickland inside the 35, down to 33, another third down conversion, 32 yards.
Winning on third down is something that Coach Rule was very serious about this week, and Smith gets stronger as the game goes on.
Oklahoma had been beaten in man coverage. That time it was just a straight two deep zone. Two high safeties have a half of the field, and Zach Smith fit one in there to Strickland.
Zach Smith keeps it. Smith takes a hit. As we go back to the previous play on third down again.
So here's the high safety playing half the field. Strickland ends up in the hole, the area between the safety and the corner out there to the right, and fits it on a dime. Breaks the tackle. Great job getting back north. Touchdown saving tackle on Strickland.
On second down and five. That was one of those where Tony Nicholson thought, I'm about to get leveled by Stephen Parker.
Stephen Parker came in there with a real purpose, and this game is really amped up on both sides of the ball. Guys flying around like there's no tomorrow. There is a tomorrow, but not when you're in Big 12 play like this.
By the way, look at those numbers for Zach Smith. He has outplayed Baker Mayfield based on numbers.
No question. Right here, another conversation in Baylor's headsets. Third and five at this yardage, right in that dead area, be a 45-plus yard field goal. Could be four down territory.
Is that a lateral? They're going to say it's just a forward pass incomplete.
Really close. Those are tough ones. If you don't get that guy in a landmark, if you get a lot of hands, it could be the defensive end. It could be the defensive secondary player here driving the receiver. Very close to being a backward pass. That appeared to be forward, though.
Yeah, a little bit.
That's all you need.
Just a skosh, and they are going to kick it, Coach.
46-yard field goal attempt for Connor Martin, who connected on 41. That was a career long. This would be a new career long. Turnover. 21 straight scored by the Bears, and that kick was just about perfect. Wow. Don't go anywhere. Something's brewing here in Waco.
Nationwide is on.
After the fumble and a field goal, 46 yards by Connor Martin. It's now a 3-point lead for Baylor. Seven plays, 40 yards, 21 unanswered by the Bears. Marcellius Sutton is back deep. Galitz putting it a few yards deep in the end zone. And Sutton will take a knee. Start your Sunday with Fox NFL kickoff at 11 Eastern, followed by Fox NFL Sunday at noon. Then the Giants battle the Eagles, where the Seahawks face the Titans. Check your local listings. The Saints and the Panthers in Charlotte. Right now, Oklahoma down by three with 2:45 to go here in this third quarter. And I don't think anybody thought this would happen. And I don't think anybody thought this would be the comparison right now, with Zach Smith getting the better numbers than Baker Mayfield.
We thought we were going to see Charlie Brewer, the backup to Zach Smith. That doesn't look like that right now. And right now, this is Baker Mayfield's time. He's got to write his story and be that confident guy and lead his team.
Mayfield on first down. Completes the pass. No flag. And it's Jeff Badette. Is just shy of the first down marker.
Really good first down call there by Lincoln Riley. I think this is their best deal. The hard sell play action pass, take advantage of matchups or find the seams when they do happen to play zone. Second and inches, time to take a shot.
It's Abdul Adams getting the first down. Guys, how about this? The first four drives of the game, 17 plays, 300 yards, four touchdowns for Oklahoma. The last four drives, 19 plays, 69 yards.
Well, for the most part, Baylor has done what they came in trying to do, which is eliminate the big play, and they've done that in the second half, and that's about adjustments at halftime.
Yeah, if you watch these safeties, the guys line up here in the 45-yard line. One of those guys continues to run back to the middle of the field and protect that home run threat. The biggest thing in all that, they have 0 points on all those plays.
Under 2 minutes to go here in this third quarter. With the hole, slips a tackle. And he finally gets tackled by Harrison Hand at the 47 of Baylor, a 20-yard run by Abdul Adams.
We talked about Lincoln Riley answering the questions by seeing his tailbacks perform. Again, Abdul Adams is answering a lot of those questions, and he is getting the majority of carries here in the second half.
I can't believe he has anything left.
Adams again, staying with a hot hand, and Adams up to the 33-yard line.
It's a great job by the center and the left side of the offensive line. As a Baylor guy is down, they're bringing the blitz from the boundary. Everybody from Baylor has to get back to the field, but you can see a wide gap that the OU offensive line created.
There's a flag on the field, and Chris Miller is down right now for Baylor.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 6 of the offense. It'll be a 15-yard penalty. It'll remain first down. That's number 6, first unsportsmanlike conduct foul of the game.
That, of course, is against the quarterback, Baker Mayfield.
And it's like basketball now. You get two of those, you're done. And we can see it all day long. They're baiting him there in his face. He's kind of brought that upon himself.
Well, in case you're wondering, Baker. Scoop said to the Baylor players, quote, "You forgot who daddy is. I'm going to have to spank you today."
Well, that'll get your opponent going. And of course, on Instagram last night, he was around midnight talking about how the kid is in town. Hashtag the kid is in town, a little third person reference to the people of Waco. And seems right now they're up for the challenge, the whole Baylor team. And Baker Mayfield is a confident quarterback, as we see Chris Miller getting up and walking off the field. Confident guy. His running backs have taken him down the field, and he set him back with a penalty.
You can see this kid thrives off that. I mean, he's a confident dude, and he's being who he is. Sometimes that's a good thing. Sometimes that leads to first and 25.
12 of 17, 233 yards for Baker Mayfield, a guy who coming into this game was a front runner for the Heisman Trophy.
It'll actually be first and 10. It's only first and 25 if they chop the ready for play, and then there's a personal foul. So it's first and 10, just 15 yards back.
Trey Sermon is now in at tailback. Abdul Adams gets a break. He's only gone for 158, a career high. Mayfield on play action. Down the sideline, has the man. Touchdown, Oklahoma! Jeff Badette, 48 yards. Well, there's Baker Mayfield answering after the unsportsmanlike conduct.
Well, that's one way to get your team back in it when you set them back with a 15-yard penalty. Beautiful ball.
No questions here. So Badette was the man in motion. Get a skinny post route that clears out that void. He runs the wheel route up the sideline. And a great finish just beyond Henry Black, who's been very physical, had trouble covering the speedster.
Austin Seibert on for the extra point. Once again, Oklahoma back on top. Baker Mayfield just got called for the unsportsmanlike. How do you like me now? Finding Jeff Badette down the sideline. 48 yards for the touchdown. What's the reaction? I can't hear you. 4-point lead, Baylor. Excuse me, Oklahoma. Badette had that 70-yard kickoff return to open up the ball game and set up the short field position for Oklahoma. Now has a 48-yard touchdown and gives Oklahoma the lead. That 48-yard touchdown was the sixth pass tonight of 20 or more yards for Baker Mayfield.
You throw it that pretty, you can Instagram whatever you want.
Lincoln Riley talking with Baker Mayfield. Tristan Ebner is back, waiting to receive, hoping to get a chance to return one from Austin Seibert. Has not had a chance yet. And he still won't. Let's go back and take a look at that touchdown pass.
Go back to, here's Badette. He starts in the slot to the top. He'll come in motion to the boundary, the left short side. Clears out Harrison Hand with the post route. There he is on the wheel route. Perfect throw and catch by Mayfield. Henry Black can't stay with him.
There's really one thing that I've noticed throughout the game on both sides of the ball is that the team speed of Oklahoma is amazing. They get sideline to sideline, and that is the mark of an elite program, and definitely the Sooners are that, and that's really what that was, just edging people to the outside with a quarterback that can hit anybody on the run, and now Baylor has got some work to do.
Baylor down by four, 55 seconds to go here in this third quarter. Kept by Smith. He fumbles the ball, but they're going to say he was down. Caleb Kelly picked it up.
Just tries to pull this too late. He's on his third step, and he tries to pull it out. No question, he's down. The ground causes the fumble there. Second and 12.
You ever coached that mesh before?
That mesh is hard to coach, and he's trying to make his decision too late. But the proper read, just one step too late.
Second down and 11. Nicholson in motion, the handoff to him. Nicholson up to the 28, gets four. Third and 7. Let's see if this will be the final play. If that was the final play of the quarter, as Zach Smith and Baylor walk towards the sideline. And that will be it.
Hey, if you're Matt Rhule, and we said yesterday, hey, it could be a 4-point game going in the fourth quarter, he would have took that right then.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. Baylor and Oklahoma battling here in Waco in the Big 12 opener. We head to the fourth, and it's a 4-point game.
Next Saturday.
We've had scoring in every quarter so far. It's a 4-point lead for Oklahoma as we move to the fourth. Baker Mayfield just let his team down. And a 48-yard touchdown pass to Jeff Badette to take the lead. Third and 7 coming up here for Zach Smith and Baylor at their own 28-yard line. Smith incomplete to Denzel Mims. Those two were not on the same page as far as which route was supposed to be run.
But looked like Smith wanted Mims to run a bit of an out route. Yeah, to the marker, and Mims, they're talking about it right now, thought he had a vertical.
Yeah, it looked like they were trying to run that same kind of stop or comeback route right at the depth of the first down marker. Just a miscommunication. Opportunity for OU to turn the field.
Drew Gaylitz to punt. CeeDee Lamb back. Lamb, fair catch. A little bobble, but he makes the catch at the 24-yard line. With 14:48 to go here in Waco, time for a game break. Let's go back to L.A. and check in with Greg Wolf.
Justin, thanks. We go to Kinnick Stadium, fourth-ranked Penn State.
It seems like this Saturday is that day where you just have to kind of survive in advance.
7-5.
Like what inning is
it? Two-out double. Yeah.
What inning in Iowa City are they in?
Trey Sermon is in at tailback for Oklahoma as they start at the 25. It's Sermon on the carry. Breaks one tackle. A good run by Sermon, the true freshman.
And that's hard for a guy like Trey Sermon from Marietta, Georgia, just a freshman who was waiting and waiting and waiting for his opportunity to touch the ball. Doesn't happen till the first play of the fourth quarter.
Second down and four. Mayfield running the option. The pitch to Sermon. Sermon has the first down up to the 41.
Great design there. They've got the pullers going one way. Baker Mayfield and Trey Sermon go the other. You can see the pullers here create some just eye violations, they call them, on defense. Great job by Sermon going north and getting the first down. Trey Sermon, who's one of the most highly recruited guys in the country from the Atlanta area, a great player. And you're just in the mix and one of four for OU at tailback.
Abdul Adams, 158 yards, and now flags. Looks like too many men on the field here for Baylor.
Illegal substitution on the defense. 12 players in formation.
That's a second one.
5-yard penalty, still first down.
Yeah, Chris Miller just got the signal wrong. Coach Phil Snow, the defensive coordinator, tried to mix up his personnel groups. He said he loves to play a ton of guys. That's not what he wants. He likes 22 guys to play during the game to create a great practice atmosphere. I thought that was a great point by Coach Snow.
Creates the competition in practice. Mayfield rolling out. Throws incomplete. Intended for Jordan Smallwood.
Now, in the third quarter, we saw this Baylor defense come out with great aggression. And Taylor Young and guys like that were running around making big hits. They took the game to Oklahoma. Is that going to translate into the fourth quarter? Do they have enough juice? Has Coach Snow played enough guys to where they're not tired enough to where they can stand up to Baker Mayfield here down the stretch? Or will Baker Mayfield be a hero as he has been so many times for the Sooners over the years?
Second down and five. Hand off to Sermon. Sermon got hit in the backfield, broke free, falling forward. Up to right around midfield, will be about a yard shy of that first down marker. Jamie Jacobs for the tackle.
And there's your point right there, Petros. Taylor Young, tackle for loss, tackle for loss, tackle for loss. Arm tackle, run through by Trey Sermon that time. Creates a third and short instead of third and long. Big difference. That's, again, this isn't Liberty, this isn't somebody else. This is OU, and they've got dudes.
Demetrius. Mayfield will keep it himself, and he'll pick up that first down.
He took a shot right there, too.
Yeah, right to the back of the head, upper back area. Clay Johnston hit him. Mayfield always pops up, though. He's a tough kid and not afraid of much.
I was talking to one of their coaches in pregame, and he said he's not afraid of a couple expletives. I won't say who that was.
Coaches don't swear.
First and 10 from the 48 of Baylor. And off up the middle, Sermon. And Sermon gets thrown to the ground by Teon Sells. But not before he picks up another first down with a run of 12 yards.
Great job again here by OU. The pressure's coming here. Watch Dimitri Flowers. He scores touchdowns, and then he fits the backside to give Trey Sermon a running lane. That's exactly what you want to do against zone pressure if you're Oklahoma.
Sermon again. Xavier Jones with a tackle, a pickup of four for the true freshman Sermon.
What an interesting decision by Lincoln Riley to go with the true freshman here in the fourth quarter to carry the mail and try to take it out of the Baylor defense. And they are taking it out of the Baylor defense. We see a bear down right now.
It's Xavier Jones, the Baylor Bear player who just made the tackle. He is down. We'll take a break here with 11:35 to go. 4-point lead for Oklahoma. Xavier Jones helped off the field. 6'3", 235-pound junior. Second and six. They keep it on the ground with Sermon. And Sermon gets wrapped up right away by Tyrone Hunt. It'll be a loss of two on the play. That's a big play right there by Hunt.
Yeah, this sets up a big third down. You can see Hunt breaking through right here. Big tackle for loss on the big true freshman who's been so good on this drive. Sets up third and eight. Again, this is another dead zone. Oklahoma's kicker is excellent. Third and eight could be a run play here to set up a potential fourth down. Or let Baker do his thing.
They're going to get him out on the perimeter to do it. They can't trust this freshman with another carry in a row.
Five on the play clock. Both coaches tried to call timeout. See
it's,
that?
It's Baylor.
Timeout. Baylor. Their first of the half. It'll be immediate timeout.
So Baylor gets the timeout with 10:39 to go and third and eight coming up for Oklahoma.
Start your Sunday with
what you like.
In this part of Texas, if you order a Coke, you can say, I want a Coke. And they'll say, what kind? You can say, Dr. Pepper.
Third down and eight after the timeout. It is Sermon. Sermon's got the first down and more. Still on his feet. Sermon, touchdown. 34 yards by the true freshman.
Just a great job again by Oklahoma offensively. Lincoln Riley, the safeties, they're in Lubbock. They're so deep, there's five men in the box. Hand it off to the big true freshman and he does the rest. I love these third down and long runs that Oklahoma's been very successful with. Again, a great job there. Was that C.D. Lamb?
It was Sells.
Yep, C.D. Lamb on Sells to get him into the end zone.
Austin Seibert on for the extra point. 42-31. Trey Sermon, 7 carries, 68 yards, all on the drive, 34 yards coming on third and eight for the touchdown. 11-point lead for the Sooners here in the fourth.
What is PlayStation?
Trey Sermon, what was that? True freshman, you can't hand the ball off to that guy, right?
I wouldn't have done it. But when there's that much space out there, you can give it to him and let him take it. He broke a tackle. He got good blocking down the field, like Coach said, from C.D. Lamb. And an amazing play call by Lincoln Riley, taking the ball out of the hands of his superstar quarterback and giving it to a freshman to take control of the game in the fourth quarter. Amazing.
Seibert once again kicking it into the end zone. Our Buick expectation shattering drive was that last drive that we just saw, and it was all about the true freshman Trey Sermon.
Great job by Mayfield getting him on the perimeter. That was a big conversion, him being physical, getting his shoulders square, and again a good chair cut. All these Oklahoma running backs can change direction and finishing the deal here. The expectation that is shattered is how physical they've been in the run game, and the true freshman, like you said, getting it done in the fourth quarter.
253 rushing yards for Oklahoma on the game. On first down, Smith taking the shot down the sideline. It's incomplete. Pass intended for Denzel Mims.
Your Matt Rhule here, you're talking to your team again. It's an 11-point game. It's a two-possession game. You're still going to run your plan with 10 and a half left, and they start with a shot.
Remember, they've had a lot of trouble on third down. They've been a lot more efficient on both sides of the ball in tonight's game, but Baylor's had a lot of trouble on third down, and it really is because they haven't had a lot of success on first and second down, so they end up in third and long situations. Let's see what they can do here and make some up.
Hand off to Lovett. And Lovett gets run out by Emmanuel Beal, eighth tackle of the game.
That was such a great job by Beal, feeling the block and then accelerating. It looked for a second like Lovett was going to break through and convert that. Just like Petro said, second and 10 turns into third and 7. These are tough sequences.
And now a timeout taken by Oklahoma. Didn't have the right guys on the field. For
Oklahoma,
third and 7.
Their first of the half. It'll be 30 seconds in length.
Well, coming up next, college football continues here on FS1 as seventh-ranked Washington battles Colorado. College football on FS1, where every game is everything. A battle in the Pac-12. Folsom Field in Boulder.
That'll be a big test for Coach Peterson's team. Colorado very solid on both sides of the ball, replacing some guys in the secondary, but that offense is intact. Should be a great one.
Tim Brando, Spencer Tillman, Holly Saunders with the call. Justin Kutcher, Mark Helfrich, Petros Papadakis here with you in Waco, Texas. Mark Stoops is watching as well.
That's Mike Stoops.
Mike Stoops.
He might be watching from Lexington. Yeah, the sideline is helping Zach Smith and the young front, adjusting protection, getting in the play that they think is ideal for this crucial third and long.
Third and 7, pressure coming. Smith throws high, incomplete, intended for Tony Nicholson. The pressure stepped up for Oklahoma.
Excellent disguise by Oklahoma. They stayed in a too high safety look. The two safeties stayed deep and didn't show the blitz. Got the pressure to Zach Smith and really wisely throws it away there instead of taking a sack.
CeeDee Lamb is back. Drew Gaelitz to punt. They need a big one right now. Does Baylor. Fair catch signaled and made at the 19. A 53-yard punt. Here in Waco, Oklahoma certainly getting a test from the Baylor Bears. Some hard hitting, some big plays, certainly a
Liberty Mutual stood with me when this guy
11. Time of possession fairly even, but the yards certainly in favor of Oklahoma, 534 to 391. They've also set a new Oklahoma record. Field takes a hit and a flag comes in late, not near the sideline.
Two officials over on the sideline where the hit took place, but like you said, Justin, the flag came from more the middle of the field. Great play call.
Yeah, just inside zone, and Baker pulled it off. There being no defender
holding
back to the field.
Offense, number 81. It'll be 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, and we'll replay first down.
Mark Andrews, great tight end. There he is. Just gets those hands extended. You got to keep driving your feet and run to your goal line, and that won't happen. Anytime you're backing up as the offensive player, you open yourself up for that call.
So now it's first down and 8 instead. Mayfield hands off to Sermon. Sermon used a stiff arm, gets outside. Sermon down the sideline, tight ropes. Sermon off to the races. Trey Sermon gets tackled, horse collar tackle. The flags come down. Trey Sermon, wow, what impressive. True freshman.
Trey Sermon, this is why this kid is so highly recruited. Doesn't have necessarily crazy breakaway speed, but so physical, great feel, really good job of staying in bounds. Again, where a lot of guys are running out right there.
60-yard run.
looked like Vaughn's with the great effort to really run him down.
Horse collar tackle. Defense number 37. A penalty being forced half the distance from the end of the run. It'll be first down, Oklahoma.
I think it's against number 27, for Kendrick Vaughn's.
Yeah, again, like Petro said, great effort. Misses one tackle. And this big point of emphasis this year, any contact to that nameplate area up in the that's a textbook call right there.
Save the touchdown. You got to save the touchdown. Get him down. That's a big man running down the field. And I'm really impressed with this freshman. And shocked we didn't see him earlier in the game.
He's over 100 yards on the night.
In the fourth quarter.
Yeah, on eight carries. Abdul Adams had 164 yards.
Must be reviewing. Did he step out or not? Is that what they would be reviewing?
See it on the sideline. Great job right there, putting that left foot in the ground, running through that tackle. He's good there. Petros?
He's out.
Was the heel out or was it above the line?
Maybe the heel was out, but I don't know if that's enough to overturn it. And then does the horse collar count if he was out of bounds?
Never happened.
I saw it happen. You're going to tell me USC didn't play in that game in 2006 now.
Has to be conclusive.
Justin, I think like you said, it looks like his heel is off the ground right there.
What awareness by a young player.
Again, you see so many guys run out of bounds right there. And I think, again, that's a byproduct of having four guys that are in constant competition for playing time.
Let's get the call from Brad Van Vark.
After review, the ruling on the field stands as called. First down.
Not conclusive evidence to overturn the call.
Or confirm, but looked like, it looked like his heel was off the ground.
So, by the way, the horse collar also stands.
Yes, because it happened. Baker Mayfield, not as much of a factor here in the fourth quarter. It's been all about the running back.
13-game winning streak for Oklahoma. Longest in the nation. Trying to make it 14. Sermon. Why not? Touchdown. 9 yards by Trey Sermon. It's been all Sermon. He's preaching here in this fourth quarter.
Very appropriate on the Baylor campus, but great job here again. Play design. Got Badette in motion on the fly sweep. Just draws one guy outside and makes it an arm tackle on the physical Trey Sermon right there. Taylor Young, again, we come back to how physical and just he's just worn this team down almost single-handedly.
I think Taylor Young's out of gas.
No question. Along with those big guys up front have done an exceptional job in the fourth quarter.
The extra point is good. 49-31. It's the Trey Sermon Show here in the fourth quarter for number 4 in Oklahoma. He's got 137 yards all in the quarter. Happy New Year.
He has brought
everybody celebrating that.
The gnashing of teeth to the Baylor defense. There's no doubt about it. And just a rolling ball of butcher knives, that running back going forward. And Baylor just could not tackle.
And the Sooners have taken over, guys, courtesy of the run game.
Well, it started out with Abdul Adams, and he really was running the ball with a lot of firepower early. Of course, he had the long 99-yarder, the longest play from scrimmage in the history of Oklahoma football. I don't think that one's going to be broken anytime soon. And then the true freshman comes in, Trey Sermon. Very patient play calling. Very good use of personnel by Lincoln Riley, and Sermon was just the number to call. to grind down the Bears defense. Both of those guys have had a heck of an afternoon running together.
And that all combines to a 334-78 run game edge for Oklahoma.
Zach Smith on first down, gets it, but completes the pass to Denzel Mims.
I guess they don't miss Perine and Mixon that much.
You know, it's funny because we came into this broadcast, Petros, remember talking about how it was Baylor who wanted to make or had the emphasis on the run game, getting Terrence Williams back. They wanted to try to run the ball a lot in this game.
They did, but their quarterback has played excellently.
Smith again going up high. Did he come down with it? Did Mims get it? He did. Wow. What an acrobatic catch by Denzel Mims going up against Jordan Thomas. 26-yard completion.
It has been a tough day at the office for Jordan Thomas on paper, but that's a 50-50 ball tipped. Razzle dazzle. There it is. That's good in the NFL. Both feet were in.
And Coach Rule was talking about that. Somebody's got to go up and make a play sometimes when we throw it.
Is under further review.
And Mims had the one-on-one matchup and did come down with it. It looks good. They are going to look at it.
You know Mims' hometown?
Yes.
Dangerfield, Texas.
Hard to get respect there.
Danger's his middle name.
We went in two different directions.
Yeah.
Let's bring in Dean Blandino once again from L.A. and get your thoughts, Dean, on is this a catch or no catch?
Looks like a catch to me. The first thing you have to look for, when does he establish control? Looks like he gets it in both hands. The right foot is completely inbounds. You have the toes come down first, then the heel, but it's inbounds just before the left foot touches out of bounds. This looks
after
like a catch.
Review,
I haven't seen anything to overturn the
ruling on the field.
The ruling
of a completed pass is confirmed.
That makes Dean two for two, correct?
Dean's on fire.
All right. It is confirmed. A completed catch. Acrobatic play by Denzel Mims. 10 catches, 186 yards for Mims on the night. Smith to Nicholson. And how about the job by Treston Ebner coming over
yeah.
and picking up that blitzer?
Great fit by Ebner. Again, that's hard for a true freshman to even recognize, let alone go execute, opening up that lane for Smith to make a throw and catch.
Especially to come across in front of the quarterback yep. to make the block. Not a lot of guys will be able to see that and scan the field.
Let's go. Smith moving in the pocket. On the run, throws the sideline, completes it to Pooh Strickland for the first down as he gets out of bounds.
It looks like the Bears have found their quarterback going through the rest of the season.
Yeah, this kid does a lot of good things, and they've had a great plan going to back, you know, to what you were talking about. They've just got to continue to play clean in every phase, not give up the special team snafu. And this thing isn't over yet. Still got to keep playing, got to ratchet your tempo up a little bit right here.
Smith trying to find Ebner, who bobbled it, then took a hit from Emmanuel Beal.
That's why you have to catch it the first time, because
exactly.
somebody's coming. Emmanuel Beal very fast at the will linebacker position to get to the back once he's unable to secure the ball. It's the right read by Smith. Just a little high for a running back. You want to see it right between the two numbers when it's a running back, especially a young one. And he pays the price for not catching it the first time. Oklahoma's been the more physical team in the fourth quarter. That wasn't the case in the third.
Second down and 10. Smith pumps. Overthrows Mims. For those of you tuning in for Washington at Colorado, we'll get you out there at the immediate conclusion of our game. In the meantime, that game is available on FS2 and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. Justin Kutcher, Petros Papadakis, Mark Helfrich here in Waco at McLean Stadium. Fourth quarter, Oklahoma, third-ranked team in the country, leading Baylor 49-31, 21 unanswered by Oklahoma. But the Baylor Bears marching down the field, facing a third and 10 from the 18-yard line.
Let's go.
A Smith to the end zone, incomplete. And he took a hit as well.
Yeah, he got hit there big time. I think it was Overton that finally got home. Good job by Smith working the pocket. And he's just got a safe spot this to the front pylon to stay away from the defender. Baylor's going to kick a field goal here. It'll still stay a two-score game if this is good.
It's going to be a 36-yard attempt for Connor Martin, who's 3 of 4 on the night. 32, 41, and 46. And this one is good from 36. That snaps the 21 unanswered. It's a 49-34 ball game with 7:04 to go. Back right after this.
Hold on, Jill's texting.
Smith has been a fabulous quarterback leader for Baylor throughout the day into the night, finding many different receivers. Denzel Mims there on the post, going deep again to Mims, tightrope at the sideline and getting it to the house. Throwing the ball with a lot of accuracy that time to the speedster Chris Platt. He's been directing traffic, moving guys around, running the ball a little bit. Zach Smith has been a big bonus for the Baylor Bears today, and we thought we were going to see the backup, Charlie Brewer. We saw a new Solomon earlier in the season. I don't think Zach Smith is coming out unless he gets hurt for the rest of the season for the Baylor Bears. This has been huge for Coach Rhule tonight.
Yeah, a lot of good things are going to come out of this either way. You can see Baylor lining up here. Could be a potential onside kick. Oklahoma has their 10-man hands team with all up front with the returner deep. This is kind of in that dead zone with 7 minutes left of whether or not you onside kick this. Both teams have timeouts. There's plenty of time to work with it that way.
Both teams have two timeouts remaining. They will try for the onside, and it is recovered very nicely by Jordan Thomas. Time for a game break. Let's go back to LA and check in with Greg Wolf.
Oh, we go back to
a baseball game, high scoring one.
No.
I mean, home runs are going crazy this year.
It's so back to a Big Ten game.
49-34.
It's a fine line, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Now, good starting field position here for Oklahoma.
And I don't know what you do if you're Baylor at this point. I mean, you haven't been able to tackle this running back. You got a Heisman candidate, Baker Mayfield, sitting back there at quarterback, waiting to make another touchdown throw if you stack the box.
Handoff is to Sermon, and Sermon nearly slipped the tackle.
That is such a good 3.5-yard run right there. Coach Phil Snow, the defensive coordinator again from Baylor, brought three guys off the edge from the top, trying to overload the box, just as Petro said, keep a high safety if it does happen to be play action. Just looks like Lincoln Riley's going to milk the clock, bring that play clock down as low as possible, and pound it out here with the true freshman.
I always wondered with your teams at Oregon over the years, when you guys were milking the clock, how the offensive linemen, now they're not doing it so much here, but how those guys stayed in their stance for 20 seconds.
Well, you try to do just what these guys did right now. Tell them and not make them sit that long in their stance.
Sermon, as you mentioned, Petro's having a tough time bringing him down. You talk about Oregon, Coach Helfrich, you being there, and we haven't really talked much about this, but Lincoln Riley, the offensive coordinator for 2 years here at Oklahoma, came here when Baker Mayfield started here. He's been calling the plays for Baker Mayfield now for all 30 of his starts for Oklahoma. Now as the head coach, the transition from offensive coordinator with the quarterback to head coach with that same quarterback, you did the same thing with a certain guy named Marcus Mariota, who went on to win the Heisman Trophy. As it's third down and two, Sermon up the middle, has the first down. A flag is thrown. We'll wait for the call, but I'm going to tee you up on a question right now as we wait for this call. Is just, what is that like, working with a quarterback in that transition from going from offensive coordinator to head coach with that same guy? So you take time to think about that as we get this call.
Holding. Offense, number 58. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay third down.
Okay, now go.
You almost don't mind that call right there if you're Oklahoma. You get another play to run some time.
Hey, don't stall.
No, you're awfully smart, right? When you look at that graphic, those guys on the outside, those coaches are a lot smarter when you have the really good guys on the inside. But, no, I know, you know, Marcus Meredith, special, special player, unique relationship. You go from recruit to... guy, and I know Lincoln Riley has done a great job with a lot of them.
It's third down and 12. Let that play clock go down to one. And Sermon, he will be bottled up this time, which will bring up fourth down.
I don't know if today's been a Heisman performance for Baker Mayfield. He certainly had some beautiful throws earlier in the game and one in the second half, but people don't realize just how hard it is going back to Marcus Mariota and Coach Helfrich's relationship with him. For a guy on the West Coast, not from USC, because the East Coast bias is real, to win the Heisman Trophy. I mean, you can barely name the guys other than Mariota, who's a modern era miracle. Gary Beben, Terry Baker. I mean, there's not a lot of guys. Jim Plunkett. Those are the only guys who didn't play for USC on the West Coast to ever win a Heisman. Not Marshall Faulk, not Toby Gerhardt, not Christian McCaffrey, not Andrew Luck. So what they accomplished at Oregon with Marcus Mariota was beyond the pale for Coach Helfrich. And there he is. Can Baker Mayfield have that kind of season? He's certainly getting enough attention to have that kind of season. And the signature victory in the moment at Ohio State, Coach Lincoln Riley has got a lot to manage with this quarterback because this guy is a fire plug and he attracts a whole lot of attention.
Yeah, you can tell it's a balancing act. This guy's a confident dude, and there's some stuff off the field you're going to have to take care of, even some stuff on the field with a personal foul, but part of that is him. Part of that is what makes him so special, and you can't quell that either.
Seibert punting to Nicholson. And a fair catch made at the 14-yard line. So Baker Mayfield, he's been a Heisman candidate. Mayfield has finished fourth in 2015, third in 16, and this is how he has improved. Look at the numbers. Last year, 71% completion percentage. This year now at 77%.
Yeah, that's just so impressive. That number's going to, the completion percentage will go down a little bit most likely tonight. But there's going to be games like this that, you know, Petro said this isn't a Heisman performance. You're going to get everybody's best shot from here on out if you're Baker Mayfield. Again, some of that is self-inflicted. Some of that is just your OU.
And he's never not been a fiery player. I mean, he was a fiery player at Texas Tech. I mean, this is the style this guy plays. I don't think he can play any other way.
Well, for those of you tuning in for Washington at Colorado, we'll get you there at the immediate conclusion of our game. In the meantime, that game is available on FS2 and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. RJ Sneed with a catch, 5-yard pickup. One thing I do want to ask Coach Helfrich is this, you know, this game is not a blowout. It's been close throughout, but they will be in games where there are blowouts. When you have a guy who is a Heisman candidate, cognizant are you of trying to keep a guy in late in the game so his stats match up and he gets those stats so he is getting those votes later on?
That is part of it. You know, there's no question. You want to be able to put up those graphics and just make it very apparent to the voters and people that, you know, like Petro said, that don't see the game and how good or great the night may have been. But also by the same token, Lincoln Riley did a great job tonight of just pounding the rock. That's what had to be done against this depleted Baylor front and secondary, and that's put them in position to ice this thing.
Smith able to complete the pass to Pooh Strickland.
And you love to see Zach Smith still compete right here too. Again, I love, and this is part of Matt Rule and the growth of this program, get these guys going right here as fast as they possibly can. And good to see Zach really grow up as a communicator. Coach Rule said that's one thing he wanted to see tonight.
Up over 400 yards on the game at 405. You can add some more to that total now as he completes the pass to his tailback, Ebner.
I'd like to see him operate. Good job by Zach Smith, getting him up, getting him ready to go. Snap the ball.
Let's go.
Towards the sideline to RJ Sneed again, who gets out of bounds. Picks up the first down.
These are more teaching moments for Coach Rule, aren't they? And his offensive coordinator, Jeff Nixon, calling plays, getting on the same page with the quarterback, figuring out what they can do down the stretch, I've been really impressed with Baylor tonight. I know they're going to lose this game, and Oklahoma is a powerhouse, and they came in and did what they had to do, powered things through the fourth quarter, but Baylor stepped up today.
We have intentional grounding.
We're going to have the debate of whether or not he's in the pocket. That did not get past the line of scrimmage, so there's the flag.
Kenneth Mann and DJ Ward combined to bring him down.
It's just a young front and too many drop back passes against a
intentional grounding.
OU front.
Offense number 11. That penalty will be a loss of down at the spot of the foul. Brings up second down.
So Zach Smith has to get outside of this tackle, clearly outside the tackle, before he then throws the ball beyond the line of scrimmage. If he's in the pocket, he has to throw it to an eligible receiver. Clearly not out of the pocket. And there's the nearest receiver. Good call by the officials. It's going against the quarterback. You need to, but that's a good call. Good by the
Smith has a man open. Nicholson breaks away. Inside the 10.
2:15 to go here, Kutch. Jordan Thomas is down. Really good job by Zach Smith stepping up and safe spotting that ball.
He's found a lot of spots between the safeties and the corners when Oklahoma runs zone.
Jordan Thomas is the player down, first team Big 12 last year. Reaching for that ankle.
He's been picked on by Mims most of the night, really. Zach Smith tried to get after him. He went out earlier with something on his jersey. He had a great play picking up the onside kick on the hands team. Still out there competing late in the game.
Yeah, Parnell Motley, I think, has taken all that attack to him. He's played so well. There's Jordan Thomas right there on the bottom of the screen. It looked like either a change of direction got him right there. He just pulled up on that turf. Sometimes your cleats stick. Again, a non-contact injury for Oklahoma. A couple of those tonight.
Jordan Thomas has to be helped off the field. Secondary taking a beating for Oklahoma in this ballgame.
And that's been one of their strengths, one of their big consistencies at corner this year.
So here's one of those teaching opportunities. If you're Coach Rule, they're going to start the clock with 2:15 remaining. So get your guys out there, get them on the ball, get ready to roll. Still a two-possession game. They'll go for one if they score here.
First and goal from the 7 for the Bears.
Clock's running. You want to see a quarterback snap the ball right here.
Smith to the end zone. Incomplete, looking for Denzel Mims. On the coverage was Trey Norwood. Remember, it was Trey Norwood before who came in for Jordan Thomas, and they went right at him on a third down, and they converted.
Baylor scores here.
Onside kick, and anything could happen.
Could be a wacky finish in Waco.
They swing it out to Ebner. Has a block. Ebner collides with Kenneth Murray. True freshman against true freshman.
Great finish by the OU secondary. That is so hard to get that guy down in space. Coach Rule's going to take a timeout.
There's Kenneth Murray, the true freshman linebacker. A lot of physical gifts, according to the defensive coordinator, Mike Stoops, 6'2", 242.
First true freshman to start the opener for Oklahoma at inside linebacker in 42 years.
That includes the Boz, right?
Timeout.
I believe it does.
Baylor, their second charge timeout of the half. Baylor has elected to make it a 60-second timeout.
Well, that gives us time to talk about what's going on. We've got 60 seconds to talk about what we have here.
Well, it's third and goal from the 3.5 on a right hash. You're going to have a certain number of plays for this situation.
you could run two-point conversion type plays in a row here. You could run the ball, right, because you're going to go for it on fourth down anyway. So whatever your best thought is, whoever your hot hand is, that's what you're going to go with right here.
49-34. Third and goal from the four with 1:52 to go. Ninth play of the drive coming up.
And for as beat up as Baylor has been here in the second half, really, they played great in the third quarter, but in the fourth quarter, they've taken it in the chin. They are still playing. Coach Rule's guys are still out there competing and still out there giving themselves a chance against what looked like an insurmountable opponent about 2 minutes into the game.
Yeah. But it was 14-0 like that. Dresden Ebner, a true freshman and a tailback. Zach Smith in the shotgun on third and goal. Smith. That hole closed up quickly. DJ Ward and Neville Gallimore. And Smith comes up, hobbling just a bit. They call their final timeout.
OU does a great job matching this. They've got a bunch route to the field, and they try to sneak the tail back out, and they cover everybody, and the four-man rush collapses on Zach Smith. Great defense by Coach Mike Stoops and the entire Oklahoma defense.
Great job by Smith to keep the ball.
Yeah.
Looked like he was going to lose it there with the physical tackle there by Gallimore. Big Canada.
While we have a timeout here, let's go back, check in with Greg Wolf, find out what's going on in Boulder.
All right, Justin, thanks. Yeah, following Oklahoma-Baylor on FS1, it's this Pac-12 opener for number 7, Washington and Colorado. Opening drive of the game, Philip Lindsay from a yard out. The Buffaloes, an 11-play, 75-yard drive. They lead 7-0 early on. Justin Petros, Mark, back to you.
Greg, thank you very much. That game right now is over on FS2 or Fox Sports Go. We'll get you to that game as soon as this game is over. Fourth and goal, though, coming up here for the Bears. Score a touchdown here. Kick the extra point. Go for an onside kick.
This is another great play to learn from your quarterback and teach him right here. Fourth down, give somebody a chance. Give somebody a chance to make a play. You've got to get the ball out of your hand.
Smith, he does, back in the end zone. Touchdown, Denzel Mims. Third touchdown of the game for Mims.
Great job working the back of the end zone by Mims. Unbelievable protection in the fourth down by that Baylor front. Gives Smith enough time to and watch him come in from the side of your screen. Check the feet, check the ball. He just bobbled it. He's got it there.
It looks like the left foot is out, Coach, where he bobbles it. Yep. The official was right on top of it, but it looked like he just missed that toe.
He bobbles it there. He doesn't have possession. We'll go to Dean Blandino to check on his left foot.
He got it right inside of Norwood, the backup corner, Trey Norwood. Nice throw. He got the ball out of his hand, like you said, but you got to catch it the first time to make sure.
Great throw by Zach Smith. That ball's got to be high, just like he threw it. You're throwing that through a lot of traffic that you don't necessarily see. Perfect picture of that right there. And we always taught those guys to run the top of the letters. If you catch it in the letters, you can fall back. You can bobble it one time.
What if the letters are big?
Well, there's ruling on the field of a touchdown is under further review.
Unless you're Tennessee, then you got to run the second checker.
Well, you got everything you wanted out of your quarterback on a fourth down play there if you're Coach Rule. But Mims unable to complete the play, it looks like.
Let's bring in Dean Blandino. He's 2 for 2 so far. Dean, we've already heard Coach Helfrich and Petros, their thoughts. We'll get your thoughts on this one.
Yeah, it's that right foot, that back foot, because initially the receiver is going to bobble the football. He's going to get control. Looked like the toe was down with control, and then he brought it off the ground, and then that second foot, the left foot, hit out of bounds. I think that right foot is still on the ground when he establishes control. And I think they have to stay with the call on the field here.
After further review, the ruling on the field of a touchdown is confirmed.
Wow. So Dean was right. Three for three.
That's why he's the best right there.
Wow. You want a toe, I can get you a toe. Looked to me like that toe was out.
I think that's 3 for 3, guys, right?
That's right.
Dean, 3 for 3.
Dean, you've earned a vest. You've earned a vest.
Just make sure you start bragging, you know, tomorrow. Oh, no. The extra point is good. 8-point game, 1:41 to go. They've tried one onside kick. They'll get a chance to try another one when we come back. So Zach Smith converts to Denzel Mims, back of the end zone for his third touchdown of the night, 11th reception of the game. 1:41 to go here in Waco.
Stadium.
You got a chance.
Please recover the onside
Please
kick.
Give
Please
us a
recover
sweet
the
hop.
Onside
sweet
kick.
Hop.
They're praying in Norman too, though, guys.
We can't see that.
This is always interesting. You have to have multiple onside kick formations, adjustments on both sides just in case.
They already tried one.
Yep.
Drew Gaelitz will kick.
This is a different placement by the ball. Lincoln Riley takes a timeout to talk about it on the sideline. Jay Bowler, the special teams coach right there, will
Oklahoma.
Bring everybody together,
They're
talk about the alignment,
half.
Talk about what
It'll
they've seen in the past
in
out of Baylor special teams.
I think it was more freezing the kicker.
Could be.
So what's at stake right now for the Oklahoma Sooners as they lead by 8? Well, 13 game winning streak, that's the longest in the country. A 12-game true road game winning streak, 16-game conference winning streak. The longest for Oklahoma in their school history is 17. So a win here tonight in the Big 12 would tie that. The longest Big 12 winning streak is 21 games, set by Kansas State. All right, here we go. What you want. Mims goes up. I got it.
So good by Mims to keep that ball in bounds, and you have to bat it. If you bat it backwards or sideways, and he did. He kept it in bounds.
We're still waiting for the official ruling. It is Baylor ball.
And look who's
Caleb Young.
He's the cover boy of the game program and making plays all over the field. Again, you got to give credit to Denzel Mims. You teach that guy to run the sideline. If you get that high hop, keep it in bounds.
Man, did he show some high hops, too.
Just a great job. Watch Mims. He's just got to, it's like LeBron James keeping it in bounds.
He out-jumped Mark Andrews.
Yeah, Mark Andrews, a tight end, sure-handed tight end. That's a great picture right there. Great battle.
And by the way, that was a perfect kick by Drew Gaelitz.
Perfect. The prayers were answered if you're wearing green and yellow.
No doubt about that. And Oklahoma has tried to run clock here in the second half, and they've done a good job of it by running the ball. But here's Baylor with the ball and a chance to tie with a minute 40 left.
Got to tell your quarterback again, no timeouts. Tell your whole team, no timeouts. You're trying to get out of bounds. Don't take a sack. No penalties, obviously.
The ruling on the field is that the kick was recovered by Baylor. That play is under further review.
Wow. It looked to me like it just came right under Taylor Young.
Yeah, the only thing they could be looking for is did it travel 10 yards maybe? That they might be taking a look at that. Fourth from the bottom, there's Taylor Young right there. Mims, those are the two guys most involved other than the kicker. That looks well past the 45-yard line, which is our yellow line right there.
And touched by Andrews.
Yep. Don't see anything that would turn that ball back over.
Now watch the ball slide under the hip of Taylor Young. See how he's on it? And then it gets under his hip there, and he's got it.
exactly how you teach a guy to recover a fumble, too. Protect it. Go fetal. Get your buddies on top of you. Taking a look at Chris Miller here. It's just a question of he's blocking or getting blocked there. Would be debatable.
Well, Dean Blandino is 3 for 3 tonight. He didn't think he'd get a chance to go 4 for 4, but we're going to bring him in to find out. Dean, when they're looking at this replay, what are they looking at here on this review?
Yeah, the only thing they could be looking at here is that block by number 3, because before the ball travels 10 yards, the kicking team cannot block in that 10-yard zone. The touch was legal. It was clearly beyond 10. So that's going to be what they're looking for. And if they determine that 3 was blocking and it wasn't just a collision, then that's a foul, and the ball's going to go back to Oklahoma. They're going to have to re-kick this, but let's see what they do here.
So, Dean, what's the determination right there as 84 clearly steps up, almost like he's taking a charge in basketball, but he's kind of initiating
that whole situation.
Who's initiating
the contact? Who's initiating the contact? Exactly.
And this seems to be more of a judgment call than conclusive evidence, no?
It definitely is a judgment call. This was something that was added recently to the list of reviewable plays, but it's definitely judgment. And usually when you're dealing with replay, you're dealing with objective fact. This is definitely judgment, and it's going to be an interesting decision here, but I believe they're looking
after
at that
review,
block.
The ruling on the field stands as called. First down.
I think that's the right call.
I agree.
It's not the ball. It's not a foot out of bounds. It's two guys kind of running into it. They really had no effect on the play.
Right.
I think that's a good ruling, stands there.
Well, Dean, thank you for the explanation. We appreciate it. Buckle up. We might come back to you. 1:40 to go here in this fourth quarter. 8-point ball game. Smith rolling out to the right. Pressure coming. He's going to throw this one away.
That's great. Second and 10. You've got the ball. The clock is stopped. Throwaways always win. In this two-minute situations, you need the ball and 1 second. Those are the two things you have to have.
Caleb Kelly was the one applying the pressure. Jonathan Lovett is in at tailback.
And that's an interesting choice. Lovett, the freshman, not Terrence Williams, the junior.
Smith throws high, and it's incomplete to Mims. It was Mims who caught the touchdown. Parnell Motley knocked it out of his hands.
Looked like he took his eyes off of it. This is what we call a no-look catch. He's got his eyes on the ball, or he's got his hands on the ball, and he's looking at the defender. Check his eyes right at the end here.
Yeah.
As they look at the defender, secure the ball all the way to the tut, and he's got a first down. Thing you wonder about Williams is being so limited in fall camp, limited as in zero. You wonder how much true pass protection he's done.
Third and 10. Pressure coming. Smith loses the ball. Recovered by Oklahoma. And with no timeouts remaining, the Sooners will be able to ice it. Caleb Kelly able to recover.
And it was the very active Jack linebacker, Obo Okoronkwo, who came in and made the big play. Hadn't made a bunch of plays throughout the night, but here he is, 31.
Just a speed rush again, and it had a great play. A guy that we expected to make a lot more plays tonight, and he's been silent. Just way too much for Patrick Lawrence. The tackle out of Waxahachie, effectively ending it for the Sooners.
Guys, we said it just before, this wacky Saturday in college football, it's kind of survive and advance. And right now, this Oklahoma team, they're going to survive and advance, but they got a true test from the 0-3 Baylor Bears.
I think we can say with a lot of confidence that Baylor's going to be a lot different in conference than they were to start the season as Coach Rule continues to coach and teach and get these guys ready. And Lincoln Riley, to me, you always get your style points in conference at home. On the road, survive and go forward. And that's exactly what the Sooners have done. But the Baylor Bears will take a lot of positives out of this week from how they practiced into and out of the game.
No question. They've just got to continue to build the depth, get a lot of experience in that secondary. A bunch of guys came back for their first action of the year, either off of injury or suspension. Both of these teams have a lot to play for down the road.
Lincoln Riley will become the third head coach in Oklahoma history to start his career 4-0. 14th straight win for the Sooners. 17 consecutive Big 12 wins, ties the school record. What a game here in Waco. For Mark Helfrich, Petros Papadakis, and our entire crew here in Waco, I am Justin Kutcher saying so long from McLean Stadium, where tonight, number 3, Oklahoma survives 49-41. Now let's go to Colorado. Tim Brando, Spencer Tillman, and Holly Saunders.